Okay, ready for some more bangers only today. XDI Hero, thank you for the tier one sub. Shobes, thank you for the tier one sub and all of the many gift subs you have given. That's very kind of you. You prefer T1 versus Nongshim over HLE versus KT? Yeah, but we have to see how fraudulent KT is. That's the thing. What happened to foreplay? It's coming. Ross DeBoss, thank you for your tier one sub. Foreplay's back this week. We announced it. The new episode will be coming out. Faker player of the split so far. That is certainly an opinion. Okay. Phaetox, thank you, all the regulars here today. Will T1 win first team All-Pro this split? You know it, because Koreans can't actually comprehend the idea that the best player in their position could be on not the first place team. That's actually just, it blows their mind so hard that that could even be a possibility.
Yeah, that checks. Some mid lane attention has been paid in a couple of these games. Yeah, it's Viper. It is Viper.
Oh, we're on 14-3 this week. Very good. That means Smolder is enabled. Losing, so.
True. Not sure it's about the player. The champ just kind of struggling. Quest of ban makes a lot of
baby sleeping good. You know how it is. Smolder, Talia, Cassante. My wife is the one dealing with most of it.
That is the question. The Ash to be taken away now. Ash, kind of a guarantee you're going to see someone ban it at some point. I think unless KT have a plan, which they sometimes do, and it just straight up doesn't work, but they have a plan, right? They have a theory. It might just be the leaves smolder up, see whether they pick it, and then hit it with something.
Yeah, yeah.
Space Princess, thank you.
Will Viper just lock in the dragon?
That's the question.
How many dragons?
No, it's good. I was just fiddling with the cable.
At least the Varus just have a lot of AD pressure in the lane.
It's okay now, guys. Don't worry about it. Okay. Checking to make sure everything's going well on YouTube. It is. Very good. Okay, Vera's still going to be first pick here. Ash and Kalista banned. First pick, Vera's immediate Smolder pick for Deft.
It's going into the bottom lane either, right? So the Varus, definitely a very strong pick. Don't get us wrong. But Smolder has been pretty much guaranteed. And there's the Talia, like I was talking
about. Talia priority is going to be going up, guys.
That's not a bad one, too.
Not a bad one, too.
You'd say it's all right.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it also depends whether your players are good at the champs. Think BDD, good until they, yep, you know, safe to say.
Yeah, I reckon he's all right. Do you reckon Yone and Sejuani would really like me going into a Talia? Maybe not.
Well,
if they're going to do it.
There's a lot of skirmishing power, and it definitely feels like a pick that Zekka will have a lot of power on.
So this is the Talia buff patch, and Talia was already giga broken. And now Q is better, and E has a lower cooldown, and these are things that are mysteriously buffed. So I guess she's just going to be blind picked all the time right now. Zekka does have to worry about Talia E to a certain degree, and nice Sejuani. This is definitely a Zekka pick, by the way. Oftentimes it's banned against him.
Straightforward.
And they stay in place.
Remember the coin, the phrase squeezing the dragon when Dragon Trainer Trist came out? Smolder reminds me every time I see him, I know. His voice is so annoying. I was actually, I was fooling around with him in the practice tool this morning. When is the next Power Spike episode? Friday night.
Just see how things pan out. You can see the Rumble ban coming through. They suspect, I mean...
So Rumble's going to be banned here alongside Maokai. Going to go ahead and take the Vi to lock down the Varus. Interesting that they don't ban Tahm Kench here, because it still could be Varus Tahm Kench. Okay, they take the Delight Special Rakan. Kasante Udyr ban, saving top lane for counterpick. I guess we're just going to play Aatrox and Dinar. Feels a little bad, but that's all right. Nico is disabled in 14-3. I actually don't know. Is she? I didn't know that.
Just because there's a lot of physical damage on the side of Homolife Esports, and you could just build a whole bunch of tank items and then just feel...
Yeah, Zekka on a good Zekka champ. This is what we like to see. I concur.
I think part of the problem is that Gnar is very effective against a pick like an Ornn.
It was so sad when they removed Sion and Ornn from the game.
Yeah.
I'll ask. I'll figure it out. I'll just ask right now.
After our last series, I guess. We did see an Ornn. But that was a while ago now, so maybe memories have been tested. I like the Nami drawing. That was very cute. Unfortunately, not going to get...
That shakes up the meta quite a bit.
Yeah, but I think ultimately it's very impressive.
Public service announcement.
I'm glad you chose your words carefully.
I did.
And you said enthusiastic.
Yeah, I did.
You know, because you started
it was somewhat intentional
with an E, and I was like,
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is obviously going to be very dangerous, Sejuani Yone in the mid lane for the Talia. So have to be careful about how you use your E in this circumstance. Smolder has been played a little bit in the LCS.
Kind of suffering under the Gnar's range.
Yeah, we have seen a few of the Comet Aatroxes make their way back in. I think it makes a fair bit of sense with the lethality.
Did that boomerang just fly through Doran?
Actually just flew through Doran, yeah.
Yeah, well, don't think he needs...
Do tickets for games at LoL Park ever sell, like, usually sell out? I think so. Lion Man, sorry about your loss on the KT game. Well, did I lose? You know, we may have lost money, but also KT is fraudulent, so I kind of won either way.
They would love to get leads on the solo laners. They would love to be burning summoners consistently so that their engages are a lot easier. I think if the game slows down, KT are going to be very comfortable for obvious reasons with the Smolder.
Yeah.
But also, you know, Talia are going to hold up very well in the later stages. And if you go into a fight where everyone has Suns, I think that favors KT. So any inaction, any opportunity for Suns to come back up, they're going to be fine with.
I'm looking forward to seeing how this bottom lane is going to go. You mentioned already that Delight opted into not necessarily punishing this Alistar lane all that much, but it's Delight's Rakan. Like, he is exceptionally good at this champion.
It's interesting that
opted in KT, so obvious reasons.
Let's watch this bot lane a little bit.
So
it's interesting we're not seeing any more harassment from Delight and Viper right at level 1. Like, they do in a pretty extended leash at the red buff instead, but this means you're not going to get any kind of punishment onto the Alistar Smolder lane. I'm doing great, Henry934.
I think that favors KT. So any inaction, any opportunity for Suns to come back up, they're going to be fine with.
I'm looking forward to seeing how this bottom lane is going to go. You
like, this lane seems like it's shit, frankly.
This Alistar lane all that much, but it's Delight's...
Like, what is your all-in potential with Smolder early? And why are we doing this super big leash that doesn't actually abuse our level 1 power?
Maybe want to get a stack actually on his support item, because if you hit a champion, it's worth more than if you kill a minion. So if he wants to get the extra gold, just headbutting makes sense. taking that win to do so. And yeah, I mean, here's the thing. You get so much teamfight power from the Rakan in this composition. It's definitely got a ton of value, and as you said, Delight fantastic on it. But you can see already, like, considering Alistar is a weak level 1 champion, the fact that KT got level 2 first and they're kind of having presence in this lane shows that Delight really didn't opt in to win lane here.
Well, maybe this new Dragon champion guy is pretty good. I don't know. That's a double pulverize. Barrel getting some value, but immediately lit on.
What the fuck, man? This seems so terrible, this lane.
Has potions to heal up, and obviously the passive of Alistar as well will sustain a bit. Definitely feels like he was trading there for the support.
Why is Briar not played? She just bet. Oh, God, it's horrible.
But I'm not going to lie. Every support player said I'd do it. You know, you just go for a short little engage, get them more value from the gold, from the stacks, because those support items are so nice to have.
Well, now Beryl is going to be able to go back home, collects the.
This is a pub stomper, man.
I think it was the support, the shoes.
Yeah, he had the support.
Otherwise, you wouldn't have had your last sentence, and that would have been very silly. So even if he did have the shoes first, I shouldn't talk about it. Let's be honest. So him and Def both going back. Actually, I believe Def stayed, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yes, Briar and Nefiri, the only two champs not ever played in LCK, indeed. They're also both shit.
You can see BDD has taken a fair bit of poke damage in this lane.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of skill when it comes to Yone matchups. A big thing that has changed for Talia on the patch, I mean, we went over this at the start of the day, but...
Def is going to have his back saved.
We've got a buff to the Q base damage, but the big thing in a matchup like this is they buff the E cooldown. So
Talia E can't damage Yone on the back of his E. No, he's unstoppable when he returns to his body.
Into the Yone in particular, having your E more frequently available really helps to mitigate the pressure. And especially like when you look at the value of the Unraveled Earth in this game.
Okay, well, I know the reason Nico is disabled right now, but I don't think I can tell you guys. Anyway, it's not a big deal. It's a visual, it's like a visual bug issue. It's like a visual bug issue, apparently, so it's not a huge deal, but the most important thing is it just changes, you know, a lot about the picks that are going to be coming in, and the fact that Faker only has two champions he can play now. Why wouldn't I be able to say? Because sometimes, I mean, I could tell you, but the thing about it is sometimes there are abusable things about these bugs that they don't want spread around, and like... what the fuck is the point of me telling you? So you can go exploit it? No. I'm not here for you to exploit bugs in your fucking solo queue games. What match am I really looking forward to this week? Telecom War, BLG versus JDG. You got some epic bangers.
Hit level 6 a little bit earlier as Grand Entrance connects onto the little dragon, and then he's going to say a chew and do a whole lot of damage.
That was actually so well played.
A little bit earlier as Grand Entrance.
Yeah, this is actually really well played by Beryl. Because he gets the headbutt in, then is able to pull right as the Rakan returns. You get Smolder E, auto Q. It's very annoying. Also, it gets you a lot of little dragon stacks there.
And then he's going to say a chew and do a whole lot of damage.
That was actually so well played.
Oh, Faker has a new champion called Wei. Yes, I saw his Wei game yesterday. Of course he does. Another control mage to add to his repertoire. Can we exploit you? You can't a squishy liquid. You don't even subscribe to me.
Interrupted in his flap. Actually gets turned around in favor of KT, and now they're going for the big play.
Yep. Here is Formant in the bottom lane as the knock up on the
got interrupted in his flap.
All right, so pretty passive early game until we hit 6 here on the Vi. Nice gank here from the Talia. Does wall off the Alistar, but you can't wall off the Smolder. That's actually underrated. I think, guys, I hadn't thought about that interaction because Smolder's E can go over terrain. So that gives you an opportunity, actually, to play around Talia Wall. You can either hop over it if you're in danger, or you can cast it in a way where the Smolder can choose when to engage.
Of spring last year, when they started to gain a lot of momentum over the course of spring, it really felt like it was down to BDD being active on the map, particularly on picks like Talia, and I feel like it's just so good to see that happen again, especially you have death on a carry like this.
Shobes 572, just gifting him a gift sub. Don't encourage them, Shobes. Don't let him exploit me for free. Yeah, you can Talia Wall behind Smolder for more effective kiting. That's right. That's what I was saying. Is like it gives you a possible escape route. So it's a cool interaction with some of these terrain creating champs.
You know, it makes sense because the lethality build definitely sometimes feels like it's on a timer. It does depend on what you're up against, but this game's already on a timer. You need as much power as early as possible if you're going to win this on life.
Well, there is a little bit of aggression towards Beryl, who just picks the person that he wants to get rid of. Still, not going to quite be enough as Mom gets a bit angry. The exhaust somewhat.
Let's get Peanut's flash out of that, but
somewhat late as Peanut just locks down the kill. Very nicely done. Good answer.
Yeah, honestly, I feel like this brush being here is such a powerful one to punish when people come back to lane.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of this new brush.
And you kind of have to ward it just to negate dive, so good move to catch out Beryl there. No flash as well meant that they knew they could make that play work.
And now that CS advantage that you were talking about earlier is going to dissipate. Although there is
Smolder's voice acting is definitely one of the worst things in recent memory in League of Legends. He's so fucking annoying to listen to.
Obviously, the replay of this, I think the target selection is really good. Obviously, they commit the ult onto Viper. You see BD fishes for the knockback onto Light, so they get his flash as well. And he knows they don't need a seismic shove on Viper to get the kill. And here,
nice trap, though, from Hanwha.
Yeah, I guess Beryl just maybe overstepping a bit. Doesn't take the safe route to get the vision.
And I think maybe thought that they didn't have a ward in that brush, perhaps?
Yeah.
So that he could actually play with vision, like you were talking about?
So I think if he goes to turret and then comes from turret, very hard to punish him in the same way. He gets to turret a bit too quickly, but there he was just a bit overextended. Sejuani apparently just does enough damage to kill an Alistar.
Yeah, which is odd, but it's certainly working out in Peanut's favor. Delight and Viper.
I feel that T1 almost dropping the ball against Nongshim. I wish they would have, so all of those fucking annoying T1 fans that went into my power rankings video the instant BLG lost and were like, who's number one in the world now? I could have been like, who fucking lost to Nongshim, the Noodle Boys? But sadly, they didn't lose that third game. The third game was actually pretty dominant from them.
5 CS in the lead is BDD as he's looking for a bit of a reset. We'll see what he does manage to put together. This back just going to be a lost chapter. He does have Lucy boots done as well. Just a cheeky bub for Peanut. And he'll get back to clearing out camps. Going to be the Rift Scuttler first. So the Sejuani having a good time.
Sylvie has been performing well, and Calmy's had some good games. Ji was good. Like I think Nongshim pretty underrated, is my opinion. They're getting better too as time goes on.
You're setting up fights like these with a Smolder because he obviously isn't going to be as strong now he is later, but Death just picked up an Essence Reaver, so it's a decent spike, but I think it's going to be matched here by Viper potentially. Nope, he doesn't quite have a full item. And regardless, if you're looking to rely on a champion who scales as well as Smolder, securing any dragons you can makes such a big difference. It basically just extends the game by 5 minutes. Extends how long before you have to mandatorily fight for a soul. Extends how long before Elder's going to turn up.
Yeah, you want your opponent to not...
So he's going for the Essence Reaver build on Smolder.
...for as long as possible. I completely understand.
And
it seems like at least bot lane Smolder standard build is Essence Reaver Quick Blades, Rapid Fire Cannon, or Shojin. Spear of Shojin, right?
Yeah, I think the problem here, not so much Perfect being low, but his TP is not quite available yet. So there's a window here where Doran could come down and join in on this. And KT wouldn't have that top laner for support. So I think KT are just happy just to stall it out until they have that security. Perfect still keeps his ult as well.
It's going to be all right. So like you were talking about, that teleport is going to be up in a moment. And of course, Doran's ultimate is on somewhat of a cooldown at this level, I guess. As Perfect is now on a longer cooldown because he's just...
Oh, God. Doran played that really well. Wow.
And he's just going to have to flap away.
Not the best overall. And that might actually be enough just to signal the dragon's a no-go. You can see KTS setting up for a pick. That's kind of the saving grace here.
I mean, they have Taliyah Wall. They can do whatever the fuck they want.
Not going to find that angle, but I think that Peanut and Delight...
Well, just extending this while the dragon is alive is enough of a win. You're just trying to get to 225 stacks on Smolder, where he just completely fucking owns you. Yeah, this is the long-ass game. This is like the 50-minute game, I think. Does Smolder have one of those annoying whiny child voices like they have on some of those children TV shows? Yes. Yes, he does. His voice is so annoying. How much knowledge are you coming into these reviews, Monty? I know the winner. Are you checking draft stat lines or just who won? I don't check drafts or stat lines, no. I just know who wins the series mostly.
Kind of been a little bit of a standoff.
Yeah. More vision going to be cleared away here as Gurgic going to just start off the dragon.
There's no real point in looking at that because I know I'm going to watch the games anyway. You know what I mean?
It's just the Shyvana problem all over. Wow, it's just going down so incredibly fast. Gurgic going to lock that one up.
That's actually huge for KT. That's really good that they found this opportunity. I'm just going back to see how this unfolded, because Yone goes up, Yone recalls. They actually see the recall. They see the recall on a ward, I believe. I think they see that recall on a ward. And so they find an opportunity. No, they don't see it on a ward. They find this opportunity just to push up, get crab.
But it's just kind of been a little bit of a standoff.
Yeah. More vision going to be cleared away here as Gurgic going to just start off the dragon. The dragon going to help with the dragon.
Which dragon's helping with which dragon?
I don't know. It's just the Shyvana problem all over. Wow, it's just going down so incredibly fast. Gurgic going to lock that one up with the help of BDD by the looks.
Yep. Shalia obviously really good at securing objectives. And this is like the best thing KT can hope for. With it being a Camtech Soul. Basically ensures that you don't really need, even when Soul is on the card.
Yeah, this is great for KT.
Compared to like a Hextech Soul that you have to really be concerned about. So now KT know.
I wonder where Death's stacks are right now.
In Honor Life, it's the opposite. They know they really need to be driving advantages in this game. They can't just hope for Soul to be their auto win con.
The Sentinels have more money than C9? I don't believe so. Why?
See what they can actually do here is I think he has some sort of an idea and gets himself out of the...
Why don't you just not spoil yourself the winner, too, if you know a game you're going to watch anyway? Because I just see the winners on social media a lot of the time, so it's whatever. I also don't care who won the series. Like, it's kind of irrelevant to me. I don't care about spoilers in games, guys. I don't care about spoilers in movies, TV shows, because it never matters what happens. It only matters how it happens. You know what I mean? Like, I really don't care if you spoil every movie and TV show, every twist, every surprise. First off, because my suspension of disbelief is amazing, so I literally will just forget it while I'm watching the movie or TV show. And second off, because it doesn't fucking matter that something happens. If it's a bad twist or it's done badly, then it's not satisfying and it doesn't matter.
Elder Dragon is ridiculously overpowered for a reason.
Yep.
That's why this champion is somewhat difficult to manage. Peanut, trying to lock down the Rift Herald. Has had some driving mishaps in the past, but now, thankfully...
I mean, Sentinels is fucking crowdfunding from their fans. Like, I don't think they're in great financial shape. I have not thought more about the best game played by Five question on SI.
Through the jungle down to bot and hit bot as well. It was insane.
That is so sick.
It was the craziest thing.
Yeah, we've got Yundo like actually letting us know that was awesome.
Yeah, so for anyone who didn't see
that, that's
on you for not watching challenges.
Yeah, and Yundo is a bit of a driver as well, so he would definitely have appreciated it.
Oh, Yundo's definitely a driver, yeah.
Well, big time.
No, I didn't VOD review the Piosik Rammus game.
Gonna take an arrow to the knee. Not going to stop this cow from plodding down towards the bottom side of the map. Trying to trying to get some vision where he can.
Yeah, I think Viper won the poke war there.
Yeah, I would say so. But I think he may continue to win the poke war.
Yeah. Death still just kind of in that scaling mindset. Be interested to see how many stacks he's on now. Obviously, so do you really hit ahead of the stack here? Because I think you're saying 225 or like 25 minutes.
Yeah. Kind of that's sort of like the aim. That's the standard that you're going for. Yeah. That's what good looks like.
So for those of you guys who don't know with Smolder, the 225 stack is when he starts doing the percent HP true damage and gets the Elder Dragon execute at 1% HP. And you get stacks either by killing things with your Q or by hitting champions with any of your abilities. And Q is his like targeted on hit ability. Whoops.
If we look at the games and we think it's a bit off, we'll just change our judgment, you know?
Well, Abidity is going to try and stop Peanut from going home because they want to start the fight here. There is a decent...
Actually, buffered his dash there.
...was the dragon. Yeah, Mom was a little bit off. Going to get her eyes checked, I think, immediately after this.
Yeah, needs a triple spec savers, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
How the hell did KT lose a Smolder in this position? I, too, am surprised.
Whoa. Needs a triple spec savers, I think.
The jump scare.
I think okay. I can tell that he learned a bit more English.
Oh, gomchak. Oh, yeah. Gomchak.
Happy BDD is fantastic. It's like, whoa.
This team is just such good vibes.
It's such good vibes. And it's like, then you remember that BDD was on that Nongshim roster like a couple of years ago where the vibes were about as bad as the vibes could possibly be. He deserves this. Yeah. 100%.
So he has 125 stacks already. It'd be very late for him not to have 125 stacks because he has the cone AoE at the back of his Q.
So powerful against HLE.
Oh, yeah. Means that he's not going to be able to get caught in the blender because there is just so much lockdown eventually. So now, unless they layer perfectly, you might be able to find an opportunity to stop being just immediately
okay.
blown up.
133 stacks is the current check.
133 at 17 minutes, ain't bad.
135 now. And the thing is, the more stacks you get, it kind of like starts to snowball, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Once you get like the AoE and your abilities,
yeah,
it's very easy to just...
Yeah, the AoE on the Q just allows you to proc it across more champions. So it's every time you hit a champion, you get a stack. So it helps you... And also, it helps you farm the wave faster if you can kill, like, the entire caster minion wave with Q. And Q procs on hit, too, which is why you take, spellblade items like Essence Reaver. Interesting that he's going Shojin second here.
Yeah, we did see this yesterday. I don't know whether it actually won. So I'm going to hold that thought. Shojin going to find an ulti, and I just, Delight?
This is kind of a bit of a hype.
What the fuck is Delight doing?
Yeah, we did see this yesterday. I don't know whether it actually won. So I'm going to hold that.
He's just clearing vision when there's a Talia in top. Okay, so he's...
Yep.
He sees Pyoshik there, right? And then he decides, hey, my Yone is in my jungle. And there's a Talia in topside who is level 13, so she has level 2 ultimate for additional range. And surely, I should walk here after just seeing the Vi and knowing that Talia could just ult in. Very interesting decision making. Chain of Corruption misses. Oh, he got it too. Huge from Pyoshik. And just TP's right to catch the minion wave. Oh!
Life Esports, the Smolder
beautiful.
Kill,
beautiful.
Stolen.
Oh, that is...
You're welcome, Nidspeens. I've been having fun streaming. Have you seen Paragon returning from the depths of MOBA hell, says Bruska on YouTube? Yes! I have. How's my wife doing? Great. I do find it interesting that I got like picked up by a Korean developer. I thought Paragon was kind of underrated, frankly, guys, years ago. Tiny bit of a macro blast. Here you guys go. There you go. It was a small macro blast.
I had to learn that name on the fly when Paze decided to build it. Very impressed that you just had that one in the back pocket. As all right, Zekka is going to immediately change his mind, as you could see. Bit of damage from Def, though. It's starting to stack up.
Yeah, breaking the mid-tier one pretty big for Hunter Life Esports.
I have not seen that yet, lol. Oh, man, we've got so many now. You guys haven't seen all of them yet.
Yeah, the fact that the game has just gone so slowly. 3 kills at 20 minutes. 1,000 gold lead for the Smolder. This is definitely not how they want things to be panning out.
Yes, my baby cannot speak language yet. And my other child is becoming bilingual. That's one of the reasons why we're in Korea, guys. Will we see Susie coming back to the scene? She's pretty down on esports. Kanata, thanks for your Twitch Prime sub. She's pretty down on esports, guys. She was part of the days when it was more about like community and grassroots organization. She's not really into the big corporate nature of it now. So I don't know if she's coming back. Do you change your diet when you move to Korea? I mean, yeah, I eat more Korean food. What kind of question is that? Although I do have a... speaking of not eating Korean food, I do have a burrito that I made out of carnitas that I made. It's rice, carnitas, pico de gallo, and queso that I made for the Super Bowl that I have to eat, and some avocados. So it's delicious.
Trying, but they really need to start finding plays where at minimum they're burning summoner spells.
Right now Deft is just sort of wondering, okay, we'll just start the Baron. That's a way of doing
it. What?
They have a blue trink on Deft.
And Deft is just going to, I think you could see there,
yeah, he did
the ring, so he's able to spot out that this is happening.
Nice attempt to sneak.
That sort of play,
why not go for it?
From Hunter Life Esports, but I think it's kind of showing the mindset that they have right now.
Can I get tomatillos in Korea? I haven't seen them. I'm going to go ahead and guess no, but I would love to be able to get tomatillos because I would love to make some like chili verde. And I really like tomatillos, but I don't think I'm going to be able to make chili verde here. I have a good carnitas recipe. I do. It's an Instant Pot recipe. Hold up. I'll give it to you. It's an Instant Pot recipe, so I can use it here in Korea.
It's looking a little bit worrying. KT now have control of the Baron. Yeah.
Yeah, approaching critical mass. This is honestly the way you have to make something happen now. You leave it any longer and you're dealing with a different...
Where are my mobile bookmarks? Come on.
30 stacks until the Smolder is online. And it really does feel so similar to Corki, and that is such a worry. Because he's a very cute champion, you know? Like, it's cool. I like dragons, like a lot.
Well, you know what? I love cats, and Yumi exists, so think about that one, right?
Oh, that's true. I love corgis.
This is a pretty fire
yep. Why are the cute champions?
Instant Pot recipe.
So annoying. Yep. I guess Teemo has existed forever, and so we've known this.
Yeah. Seems like
it's the dawn of time, you know?
You just have to go to a naval base. They're standard every commissary. Oh my god, dude. I mean, if I had to drive to the military base, which is like way south of Seoul, I'm never getting them. Any thoughts on Anthony Bourdain? I think his show is really good. He went to my college, actually. He didn't graduate because he left and went to the Culinary Institute, which is down the street from my college, so he could become a chef. But he did start by going to my college.
Udia? I don't think Udia is extraordinary. Oh, and he is very cute, with the definitely not Udia skin, especially the old
one. Are we allowing skins? I guess you're making the argument for Corki.
Yeah, that's true, based on a skin. Yeah. Base skin Corki is actually, like, one of the saddest base skins.
Yeah, I kind of like the little fighter jet one, where it's like the pixel.
Red Baron?
No, I mean that
one. Oh, the pixel. Yeah, I know that.
Yeah, that one's fun.
Arcade Corki,
yeah. Okay, Hunter Life Esports going to start this. KT don't need to fight this. You know, they might. But
they might because they feel like it. Yeah. All right, we teleport. We're fighting. Let's see whether they can actually lock down the Drake. The answer is no, as Chains of Corruption cut in. Beryl's going to ult it, as immediately the seismic shove is going to connect. Mom yells at...
How does Casey lose this, for real?
Happens, and there's the snipe from Viper, who's just to the north, and they're just fishing the barrel right now. As Doran,
force Doran to flash. Doran's going to be mega soon, though. He got deft. He just got the stacks, guys. He literally got the stacks during this fight because there was a Q that doesn't have the execute. He got the stacks right there. Oh, that's so dangerous because now he's got the true damage percent HP. Oh, God. He got in the middle of that fight. How the fuck do they lose this, guys? Barrel like chasing after a little bit of a miscommunication there, but KT, man, holy shit.
And that was such a chaotic fight where KT didn't need to take it. There was no obligation. They didn't get the dragon, but they felt like they could get an advantage. And
yeah, let's watch Viper in this.
I think initially, you know, I think Piosik maybe didn't have the right call here. Old Zeka, it ends up kind of just...
So they force Alistair ult by using Chain of Corruption. Nice snipe. Woo! Max range Q.
The big thing is they never really resoundingly got into depth. You know, there were moments where they did actually connect on him, but the damage wasn't there, you know? The E from Zeka comes out to kite away.
Really nice positioning by Viper. Look at that. Beautiful. Right at the edge. Q. BDD comes forward.
Looks like the damage is coming through. The wall connects as well. And then it gets a bit funky.
It definitely does get a bit
funky. Q onto BDD. Aw, man. Oh, well.
We've got the seismic shove coming back as well as Mom gets angry.
Then it gets a bit funky.
It definitely does get a bit funky.
All right, let's take a look at this. So we're back around the Baron pit. No Talia wall. We're going to go in, engage straight onto Vi ult, and then he gets killed.
Mom gets angry. Zeka dives in, but I don't know whether he feels that great about it as Deft is flapping around.
He's going to die.
Double kill for the dragon.
Ike Smolder's a fun champ, guys. I'm into this champ. I think he's really well designed. He doesn't, like, he has a very clear kit that is fun. You know, it's not a bunch of bullshit. Like, the stack thing is makes sense. He scales, like, really satisfyingly with items, with, like, ability haste.
That a team with Piosik and Beryl could, for the most part, patiently wait until Smolder got 225 stacks. That is just mind-blowing to me.
Well, we know that they waited. I don't know how patient...
But yes, his voice lines are terrible. He is extremely annoying.
Sit there and go, just wait the whole time.
Couple more minutes, and yeah, they try to go for a pick on Barrel, which, on a list of targets, you know, probably 5 out of 5 for who I would try and start a fight on the side of KT.
I think Deathlike did, like, 2 things.
And
then they just burnt down.
That's all he needs to do, right? Yeah. You press Q. Maybe you press Alt or W occasionally if you're feeling like it. Maybe an E here.
Yeah, how does this go on for 20 more minutes? 25 more minutes.
Great.
A great question.
And then they melted.
Yeah, they really did.
And then they exploded. And when the line came up, there've only been 4 Drakes taken. It's 2 apiece. Okay, there is a seismic shove. Pina is going to be with... Piosik under the
whoops
turret, so he's definitely going to die. Mom doesn't quite do enough damage. Doesn't quite do enough damage.
Still going for the...
Sounds a little bit too much like Godzilla.
It does sound a lot like Godzilla. I agree with that, Liz.
Yeah. It's a bit Godzilla.
A bit, yeah.
Wait, you know how every champion has, like, login music?
Yeah.
Was it P. Diddy that did Smolders? Because they did it for a track for Godzilla as well, back in the day.
I don't remember that.
They want the stupid cutesy design in all their champs now, that or waifus, yep.
It's,
That's the Chinese influence, man.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool.
Okay, maybe you're selling me on it.
Yeah.
Maybe there'll be a skin. It'll be like, you know how you have the NASA skin?
Yeah. Oh, the one where he's got the boombox?
Yes. Maybe they'll do one of those skins for Smolder. And he'll play that song.
Need it. Yeah. Full Metal Smolder or something.
Yeah.
I'm down.
Look at Nefiri. Yeah, she's a hot bitch.
Battlecast, yeah.
Is that it?
Yeah. but they could also do, like, Pentacle Smolder. I feel like it's
You're pitching this like you expect this champion to be around for a while. And based on what I know about broken AD carries, we're in for the long haul.
Yeah.
Piosik a little bit liberal with his health bar. maybe a bit too much there.
His health bar was...
Pool party Nefiri win.
And Deft has a frozen heart. Because why not?
Because, like, what items he builds is irrelevant. He wants...
Yeah, I think we've kind of learned with Smolder is once you have the stacks,
Steel, okay.
Able to lock down the dragon. Mom yells once again as Delight gets...
Beautiful engage from Delight.
Once again has to flash, but Pyoshik is down another...
God, Deft is so scary, though. Look at their HP bars.
Deft is burning them.
Oh my God, are they going to do it? That's so lucky. Perfect was dealing with... I mean, let's go back and look at this. I mean, Deft has all sums up, too. I'm really surprised they were able to pull this off. It turns into the 50-50.
Why not?
Because, like, what items he builds is irrelevant.
Are you going to watch Avatar The Last Airbender on Netflix for Nerd Legion? Yeah, that's next episode next week. I mean, that doesn't do any damage. Like, the Deft's ult doesn't do any damage. Like, it doesn't actually hit anybody. Yeah, it goes down. They wait for the E from Talia to go down. Then Delight dashes in. I mean, Delight plays this super well. Forces the cleanse on a Deft. He flashes right away. Has Ignite burning onto him. And the tank line just melts.
But he's still gonna go down, everyone. Deft once again has to flash. This is a catastrophe, but Peanut's able to lock down the dragon. Mom yells once again as Delight gets the quickness over everyone. Deft once again has to flash, but Pyoshik is down another time. Barrel trying to tank dragon. Mom yells. Items he builds is irrelevant. He wants ability haste.
Yeah, I think we've kind of learned with Smolder is once you have the stacks,
this is a catastrophe, but Peanut...
Why is Pyoshik ulting Peanut? Like, Peanut already ulted. Why the fuck are we ulting? Why the fuck are we ulting Peanut with Vi? He's actually trolling, guys. They don't need to engage right there. He needs to peel. He needs to peel for his carries. And with Sejuani ult down, he can't do that.
Kill Viper, did manage to succeed.
I don't know why he's ulting the fucking pig.
To get the backline access, it felt like KT just weren't completely ready for the fight, and they just find the follow through in the longer fight. Deft's position gets compromised. All summoners down beside KT.
How did he die with a frozen heart, though?
Delight plays it super well, though.
Critical mass.
Yeah, so unfortunately, the front line in Barrel and Josek don't get to do much.
I mean, he forced both his thumbs at the start of this fight, and he got chunked out. I'm not sure what hit him, what the damage was. Oh, it was a Q. It's a Q from Varus. That's huge.
Deft also eats a Q from the Varus, loses half his health. And here, he's just too low. He has all these threats diving towards him. He's trying to get the damage out, but they're committing flashes to CC him.
Yeah,
and he just doesn't get to play the
game. Combo of Pyoshik kind of trolling that in Delight. They need to understand that the win condition in that situation is just kiting with the Smolder and the Talia. And so you have to save CC if you're Barrel and Pyoshik to lock down any backline threats.
But I imagine you've got Zekka saying, "Nah, don't worry, guys."
Yeah, Faker's Sway was legit for sure.
The big thing is that Zekka still has flash, and no one on KT has flash. So if he gets on Deft,
Have you run into any Mexican restaurants or dishes while in Korea? Yeah, it's more popular now. There's definitely a lot more Mexican food here than when I lived here the first time.
It just starts to look more and more and more ridiculous.
Yeah, he's going to keep getting stronger.
Yeah.
Infinite scaling champions.
Yeah.
Do that.
Why isn't Viga this broken, though? Why isn't Nasus this broken, though?
Because they nerfed him into the ground.
Making cooking content? I have made cooking content in the past, but not recently. I can't do it right now because all my cooking shit is in the States. All my cooking content shit. And also, I'm just too busy to do that right now, guys.
Yeah, I think part of the problem with Nasus is that...
The truth is you guys don't watch it as much as you, like, watch League of Legends, so... That's how it is.
...than, like, this point of the game. Because it eventually gets to the point where, like... You're gonna get shredded by the enemy AD carry, and reaching them is like a whole problem, you know?
Yeah, the kite ability factor is a problem.
It's like, you can have all the stacks in the world, but if you aren't getting to the people you want to hit, it's not gonna mean as much.
We need to just find a way to give Nasus infinite tenacity and movement speed.
The frozen heart on Smolder is interesting here, just because all of the damage that's gonna hit him in the backline is AD, so I really like this item in this instance. Seems like Korean and Mexican food would be a good mix. Yeah, they both, basically both are built on the same principles of using marinated meat with a carbohydrate. So in Korean food, it's rice, and in Mexican food, it's corn, like corn tortillas. And, you know, kimchi is amazing on quesadillas. Like, I've made kimchi with this same carnitas. I grilled kimchi, or like, you know, toasted it in a pan. Heated it up, got a little charred, and then put it in a quesadilla with the carnitas. It's fucking so good. Kimchi is also amazing on tacos. You do have to heat it, though. But they're very similar. Like, they're both chili-based, a lot of chili-based food. So you can basically mix and match Korean and Mexican food very easily and create fusion foods. Do I follow J. Kenji Lopez alt? Yes.
And Doran does have Meganar for a little bit longer. That's a massive combo. The pulverize is gigantic, but now he's dead. But Smolder is auto-attacking, and that is scary. And BDD, he's got the wall. He's going to try and trap them in the Thunderdome. He doesn't find...
BDD? BDD? Can somebody please peel for Smolder? Hello? Anybody? What the fuck, KT? Do you guys, like, not understand? I mean, look, it's a new champ, so... The problem is, though... He has to ult now, though, and that's going to be huge for this next fight, because not having Alistar ult is really... painful, considering it's one of their primary forms of engage.
BDD's nearly got flashed, but Deft still has about 40 seconds away, so this is a great window to force on KT.
And Doran...
Delight has a huge engage, though. Huge. And Deft has cleanse back up now, but he doesn't actually have flash, so he already cast his ult, but Alistar's dead because Alistar didn't have ult, even though he does get a good Q off here. Now, at this point in time, you know, you have to just stick together because you have to have this, like, what does BDD think he's going to do on the flank? He can't actually kill Sejuani, by the way.
And you know, KT felt confident. They kept Deft alive. They thought that'd be enough to win the fight, but they didn't factor in Viper's ult coming back up.
BDD as well. The Thunderdome. Rise is gigantic, but now he's dead. But Smolder is auto attacking, and that is scary. And BDD, he's got the wall. He's going to try and trap them in the Thunderdome. He doesn't find the seismic shot.
I don't think Chain of Corruption was why they came back up. I mean, it did CC Deft, but Deft doesn't have flash anyway. I don't think he gets out of that regardless.
That is scary.
And we could have potentially actually cut off the Sejuani here, but you already stopped them from getting Baron, and this fight was far from ideal because you fought it without your Alistar having ultimate at the start of it, right? I mean, he does get a massive pull here. Because nobody's going to help Daft. And the thing is that you have to ask yourself, what's the price of losing that fight? Because if you just walk away, they can't take Baron. And you're not going to get Baron either. But if you over-pursue that and you die, then you give up the Baron, right? So the cost of pursuing this is just not worth it. Particularly because, again, your forms of engage, Vi and Alistar, are gone. Yep. That is unfortunate timing. Def gets hit by it too.
And that's what kills him. The root hit perfect. Transferred over. Oh man, HLE clutching it. After, you know, midpoint of the fight looked like he was going pretty boom for them, but they bounced back.
And just at the time where we thought that the stacks had come through, that the tide had turned, but that's when KT massively dropped the ball. It is also going to be the soul, as Humble Life Esports will be able to lock down the Chemtech soul. And now we've got two Elder Drakes available on the map. In a few minutes' time.
It is such a KT move.
This is, yeah, everything.
Everything about this.
Defies expectations, you know? And it's such a beautiful tagline because it sounds so great, doesn't it?
Yep.
But it's not often those expectations that they're defying. It's in fact all of them, no matter what expectations.
Look at Aatrox still building lethality. He's got another serrated Dirk, guys.
We'll see, with the Baron in check,
he's not useless. He's a Varus Assassinator. Cuckoo Garms, thank you for your tier 1 sub. Thanks for all the content money. It's a treat to have full match breakdowns, but do miss your commentary. Isn't this my commentary?
I feel like it's not really like the lane was obviously a bit rough, but just in team fights, you struggle to find the impact.
Oh, Peanut. Now possibly caught out of position. So close to being pulled back by that infernal chain as Beryl. He has to ulti, but Viper is so dangerous. And just pop.
You know, Perfect, who's normally been really solid so far, not having the best game. I feel like it's not really like the lane was obviously a bit rough, but just in team fights, you struggle to find the impact.
Oh, Peanut.
Are we going in again?
So close to being pulled back by that infernal chain is Beryl. He has to ulti.
Beryl just doesn't fucking feel like ulting. He just doesn't feel like it, guys. He doesn't feel like ulting. What the fuck, man? To be fair, that was insane damage from Viper. Q. E. Auto. Q. Blight stacks exploding. He ulted at the end, but it was too late. He didn't respect the 4-item lethality Varus damage.
Zekka is burning somewhat, and the smolder is still dangerous, don't get us wrong. He's got 6 items. But this is now KT well and truly on the ropes.
6 items smolder, this many items.
I mean, 5 items smolder. One of the items is randomly a frozen heart.
Well, true. But also, you just expect so much, right? Especially when we saw what Jiwoo was doing it, but it feels like he's just not been able to free hit in a lot of these fights. That's caused issues.
There's a lot of CC for him to deal with. There's Perfect trying to move himself out of the way. They may just blow up Zekka. He does go down to his GA, and now Mom yells at them. Beryl is back up.
That's a Force Flash, too. That's pretty good. I mean, it's pretty crazy that they're 8,000 gold down and down soul. I mean, sure, it's a Chemtech soul, but they're actually able to hold on here.
Advantage here for Deft, but damage disadvantage as far as what they've got done in this game.
Look at Windows. I want to see the stack number. I really want to know exactly how much he's at right now. It must be like, I feel like at this part of the game, with how much he's just been farming, it must be like 400.
405.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty spot on.
Yeah, and that's an absurd number. Oh dear. Okay, just sneezes into the brush. That's the best way to deal with it.
Yep, easy way to face check it. 2:45 till Baron. 3.5 till Elder, so a decent amount of time. See, Honor Life Esports, like, the gold was never that in favor of KT. There's now a substantial lead for Honor Life Esports, and yet it still feels tentative. You know, I feel like it's always going to be when you have Smolder in this game. But he's, you know, as you said, he's finished all of his items. Unless he sells one to buy something else, he's not getting any stronger, apart from the stacks.
The stacks are getting stronger is fucking huge, though. Because he scales infinitely, right, guys? Plus, the 1% the 1% remaining HP goes up, I think, based on the number of stacks that he has.
The problem is you still need a farm on smaller to get the stacks. There's no winning. Death buys a support item.
So, like, the point at which he executes is going to be, yeah, it's plus 1%. Executed once they are below 2% of their maximum health, plus 1% per 40 dragon practice stacks. So at 400 stacks, you know, that's an additional 10%. So he's executing at 12% max health. So that's really scary. The champ does get stronger because your abilities get stronger the more stacks you have. And his execute, every 40 stacks you get, his execute goes up by another 1% maximum health. Like the little line just keeps moving to the right. And yeah, he just keeps getting doing more AoE damage to your team, queuing more minion waves, like killing more minion waves with his Q. He gets to be pretty nuts. He has to keep grabbing resources. Not true, because he can proc it on enemy champions also. His wave clear also gets fucking bananas. How many stacks for 50% health? Well, you would need 48%, right? So it's 48 times 40, which is what? 1,600? 48 times 40 is, what, 1,600? But 1920, I think? 1920, yeah. There it is. That's 48 times 40 is 1920. Did it in my head. You need 1920 stacks.
They could set a vision on the dragon and ensure they can fight it and maybe look for a pick on Doran, but it does give up the Baron.
Well, I'm the only one who's allowed to do math on broadcast, guys.
Takes a fair bit of time to take him down. That does not matter because now they have a 4v5 situation around the Elder. But Zekka is now in the top lane. And Homolife Esports just want to play around that, and they can pull KT around the map on a whim.
Yeah, they just need to buy time. It's 48 seconds till Doran's up with TP. I think they can buy enough time and stop KT from doing Elder before that point. You can see Death isn't even anywhere near. And
so after AFK firing 39-20 stacks, he one-shots from 100% max HP. All you need is 4,000 stacks.
Corruption connecting onto Perfect as the Elder is down exceptionally low. Teleport comes in as BDD trying to get in position.
All right. Okay, now he's got even more execute.
But Zekka's trying to win the game. Can they stop the backs is the question.
No.
And it looks like the answer's no, and they're not even going to try for it. Zekka just gets out of there. And so the inhibitor goes down, and we have the game stop. So now it is the battle of Elder versus Baron.
You know,
I guess
the thing is, in a fight, Elder wins every day, hands down. But you don't have to fight,
yeah,
because you just clear the waves and you have a lethality.
Is Smolder a murderer for killing the dragons in this game? Feels like he wouldn't want to kill his own kind. He sold Frozen Heart for GA. I think we can understand that that's a good move. Does it stack with the Elder Dragon execute? I don't know. Yes. Yes is the answer. We just saw it, actually. This is the first time I've seen this, but if you look at this, see, there it is, and then you'll watch the bar move up. Right? I think that means it's stacking. I think it means it's stacking. The execute is capped at the higher point? Okay, then it would be capped at Elder Dragon.
Huge
chain of corruption to force cleanse there.
breaking the inhib towers is a different question.
But now we get to see Elder and Elder together.
The real question is, why is Death stepping up that far? Like, why is he... Why is he stepping up? Also, extremely well played by Viper, by the way.
But breaking the inhib towers is a different question.
Like...
Now we get to see Elder and Elder together.
He really threads that through there around the... Just really threads it in there.
That ult cooldown for Viper is very short, so...
Yeah, he should not be... He should not be stepping up on that, though.
Able to fire that off again and look to punish Deft.
Deft has not had, like, a good fight where he's been able to effectively use his summoner spells. They either get blown super early in the fight or he just doesn't have them.
And now Mom, she gets angry and flung about. Is Zekka, you cannot be dashing forward, I guess. It is just too dangerous against his composition, especially with the Elder Bar.
Now they get bounty gold off the turrets as well.
This game is just so silly. The fact that off the back of no kills or anything, this is just a bit of map control and now another ulti. But it lands on the barrel,
and I think that might be the push over. You know, they'll try and back away. It looks like it's going to reset. Health bar's low. So, sure, they got the GA from Zekka. They got a mid-tier 2, but that's about it. And it looks like they're not going to get another chance to use the Elder unless this trap wins.
When am I doing the T1 games? I'm not going to do the Nongshim games. I'll do T1 versus KT later this week.
They can see that he's on vision right now as Death.
He's like, wait, why have we not seen anyone show up on these waves top and bot and mid? Perhaps they're doing something sneaky.
Well, BDD going to clear out the top wave, so they do get information. As we're going to have a look at this one more time.
Yeah, it honestly makes me wonder. I don't think it's a bad target to go for Zekka. It just makes me wonder, would they could have probably one-shot to light, and he would have died. Like not.
Yeah, like actually died.
So, but I don't think it's a bad target. Being in the GA is definitely valuable.
Well, I do a Lord bet with Wolf over whether KT is a fraud or not. Sure, that sounds fun.
The Baron, and it's desync now. The Baron is a minute sooner than the Elder, so an opportunity for a team to get both. That is kind of what you need to end the game, it feels like, in this one. It's been so back and forth.
Well, it really feels like this stage of the game has been Humble Life Esports feeling like they just have the scaling advantage. And we wouldn't have expected...
He has almost 473 stacks now.
Scaling that a Smolder should have.
I think a big thing is that it's more about how the comps interact, you know? It's
yeah.
Like, on real life esports composition is very much backline dive, and KT's is really strong, like, backline damage.
He's at 14% execute now. 14% HP execute.
If on real life esports succeed on the win cons, it doesn't really matter how many stacks Deft has.
Yeah.
Is a big thing in this situation. And Yoni, obviously, is no slouch himself. As much as we talked about the lethality virus falling off at some point. Shredding here. Oh.
I've seen this one before as the Weaver's Wall comes down, gets the flash out of Doran as a seismic
shot. Alright, that's pretty worth, actually.
This game of the season. Surprise, surprise, ladies and gentlemen.
Shocked.
And, yeah, they got a flash from pressing a whole bunch of buttons. Chains of Corruption go wide there as well, but that sort of means about as much as Doran's ultimate. Which is not a whole lot.
Bioshik, you don't have ult, buddy.
He doesn't have cease and desist anymore. Being not able to wander his way out.
I wonder what point Deft has enough gold to just completely reshuffle his build if he were. Like, could he just, like, sell Shoujin and get, like, full crit? Or he sold his boots and gone for Navori. Could he go in the other direction and go, like, the Liandry's Riftmaker? Like, he could really just do what he wants
when it
comes to items.
I don't know whether he'd really want to. I think it's okay having BDD take care of it.
Does scale better.
Yeah.
And the Riftmaker Liandry's is, like, very good on those items, and you're very bulky. But I think, in terms of damage output, you're kind of peaking here. Still waiting for BDD to finish off his items, still lacking that Rabadon's. And obviously, Zekka and Viper in full build for a while. Zekka did sell, I think he sold Shield Bow and GA, and went for Maw and Jack Shows. So, a lot of resist there.
Definitely going to be a bit more difficult to get through. However, if they do manage to catch him again, then he dies. Speaking of dying, Peanut going to have to Arctic Assault his way out.
Stop ulting Peanut.
The Hip-Hop Orb is there. They've got the jungler. And now Perfect is looking for more. The quickness comes in. But my God, the damage. Delight has to get out of there. But it's a big ulti from Zed.
I fucking hate it. I fucking... Pioshik is... Oh, he's such a fraud. He's such a fraud. How many times is he just gonna fucking ult Sejuani this game? Why can't he just peel?
That's respective, but death actually cancel. Looking to push up mid, try and create time. Oh, no ult from Pusik there to counter that.
Alright, well, Doran is looking to try and cut this one off.
You know how I was saying the desynced Baron and Elder.
Of dying.
Well, I think he sold Shield Bow and GA.
Like, look at this.
Then he dies. Speaking of dying, Peanut gonna have to Arctic Assault his way out.
How are you gonna kill this guy? He has flash. Like, you get him, but what's the point? You use so much. Look how much you used.
He dies. Speaking of dying, Peanut gonna have.
Barrel actually just realizes, by the way, that every time he's next to Viper, he has to just. It's a great chain of corruption. He has to ult immediately, otherwise he gets detonated by blight stacks and Qs. And so they come in, but they have no Alistar ult. They have no Talia ult. They have no Aatrox ult. I mean, it's technically ticking, right? There's so much use right there, and they chase right into the Mega Gnar too.
This dragon is what's gonna have to save them, and he's very young, and he relies on his mom and things like this. But it's working out for them in this particular moment. Zekka says, "I'm gonna put threat on this inhibitor turret, and they have to go back."
That's respective, but death actually cancelled. Looking to push up mid, try and create time. Oh, no ult from Pusik there to counter that.
All right, well, Doran is looking to try and cut this. Is that you?
Wait, they're spamming pings onto the Baron. How do I like?
Are we just? Are they trading again?
Again? Yeah, I guess so.
They're trading again. But isn't that why Elder's in the game? So that doing this is a bad idea? That you have to fight for the Elder, and then maybe a winner is actually decided in the game, and that's why Elder was put into the game?
No.
No? Okay.
They're just trading.
I'm sorry. Okay. Well, it's like one for you and one for me, I guess.
Yeah, they're sharing, okay? It's nice to see our teams get along so well.
All right. And then you just base trade, right? See who's Nexus is going to go down first.
I think that's how you kind of do it in the Nexus Blitz, right? So I think get an inspiration from that.
Yeah, we're doing it. That's exactly what's happening here.
Whoa, Delight and Darren going on like some secret mission.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, KT will take down this turret and now look to go back home.
Yeah, very meaningful turret to take down. Very impactful.
Yeah. Something, something, gold, something, something, who cares?
Yeah, oh, you know, a bit of extra gold for Deft. He can afford a new red pot to refresh that. Nice, good to see.
This is the longest game of the year.
Said Zayas is probably the best player in the world. Do you think Faker can MVP over Zayas or Chovy, Cuz, or Pjosic, or the other people in contention? I mean, maybe. We're not even into the second round robin yet. Like, that starts this week. So, still have more than half the season to go.
Yeah.
And then Teddy and Bang's legacy is going to be challenged.
I would be very shocked if we got to that point. But then again,
who reaches 1300 CS first out of these players?
Thank you, Spucky, for your resubscription with Twitch Prime. Another month of bangers, Chipotle wraps, razor cakes, cake razors, trash. Thank you, man.
Spreads out.
I haven't gone into practice tool and really tested the limits.
I haven't done the infinite
and
stats
tested
yet
the
either.
Limits of what Smolder can do. So I'm ready to see. Right?
Mile 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0. Thank you for your Twitch Prime sub. Appreciate it.
Yeah. Does it get even bigger? Is every Q like mum? Q turn into mum?
Oh my! I don't think that's how the circle of life works. You're born and then one day you turn into your mother.
Well, fully
wow,
grown dragon.
It's so ridiculous.
It's so
it's
silly.
Really dumb.
And the cooldown's so short.
Is it 548 stacks now?
Okay. Well, KT are continuing to push, continuing to do things. Humble Life Esports are continuing to defend. And we might have a team fight, all right? Or we might have the turret being focused. No, we're not. The turret's fine. The team fight's fine. The wall's down. And Peanut took a damage.
Oh,
Chains of Corruption had dodged.
Close one there. Planted from Deft, which is especially impressive considering...
Chain of Corruption cooldown is so short now, it's crazy.
Bomb gets really mad. He's just testing it. Zek is like,
how much damage to do? Oh, this much.
Yeah. Are we ever going to not be in this game? Is this game just... is this life now?
Yeah.
Maybe this is it.
You know, I have like half a bottle of water here. I don't know how much you have.
No, mine's gone.
Oh.
I am going to be quite parched. Yeah. I will need emergency water. If this... Okay, just one bottle
of water.
Drink some water and maybe close it a little bit because you don't need to let it evaporate.
No, both the Baron and Dragon are synced again, so we have time, right? We have a decent amount of time.
I was going for a walk,
stretch your legs.
So apparently, if this surpasses the Jin Air versus SKT record, G-Sun can bring... She's going to bring me so many water.
Wow.
So many waters. Like bottles of water bottles. So it's not like... That is correct grammar for water bottles, right?
Just a bucket of water over your head.
I would like that. If this bait breaks the Jin Air record, what's the bet you're going to make?
Me?
100,000 gold for Hanwha.
Trying to bait me into this one?
Are you going to shave your head?
I'm not shaving my head. You know,
it's a peanut game. It's safe.
Yeah, I know.
Believe me, you never lose them.
I know another LCK caster.
A former LCK caster?
Maybe if you don't get your
water. Baldus isn't here anymore.
If you don't get your water, you might end up being former.
Hey, that is actually very true. And then you'll get the water until you'll survive. And you've already got half a bottle.
Yep, thanks for letting me live.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. Trapped on a desert island, I know that I would not be the one to survive.
Yeah, everyone asks those questions, like, what would you have with you? Water would be pretty good.
Yeah, that's probably a good start.
Clean drinking water.
Oxygen. Does the island have breathable air?
Oh, that's...
Yeah.
Never thought about that one.
That's probably the first thing.
Yeah, no one ever asked that. They kind of missed that one.
Yeah, does the island... Is it above water?
In terms of needs of people, I think that kind of is... On the upper end.
I wonder when... I feel like something's about to happen.
I think just...
Zekka moves... Oh.
I mean, he probably should buy Leandre's. You know what I mean? At this point in time. Like, in all seriousness, does he really need Rapid Fire Cannon right now? You know, does he need Essence Reaver? When he could have Leandre's and Riftmaker? Right? He doesn't need to auto if he has Leandre's and Riftmaker.
.599 stacks. We're nearly at 600.
All right, so we've got a minute until both Baron and Elder, guys.
Are we going to have... You know how we have, like, records in the LCK?
RFC for the move speed percent? Maybe. Maybe.
The inhibitor.
Doran.
And KT have already backed.
Doran, stop being cringe. Not trying to end the game.
He could sell Quick Blades and Essence Reaver, though. He could sell Quick Blades and Essence Reaver for Riftmaker and Leandre's.
Game here. We got to
stay away from...
Back away.
Yeah, there's
still
maybe seven that's the play.
7 minutes before it's an hour.
GA is the sell here? I don't think so.
Get both of the big buffs.
Yep.
It's the only way.
All or nothing.
Whoa, a teleport?
If you die, you die anyway. Not necessarily. Because, like, so here's my argument against it. Because there's a Yone, if you die to Yone and he snaps back, you can actually GA revive. That's my take. Because if you die to Yone during Soul Unbound...
What? A control ward? Deft flap?
Oh, Yoshik
Q? Oh! That was big. That was a rapid-fire cannon. That was a sneeze.
Yeah.
Bless you. Oh, arrow. Oh, more arrows.
It's possible, though.
Baron, hello. How you doing?
Wait, did you see Beryl's heal from his passive was like 400?
That's hectic.
You
He's
don't
gonna
get
have
see...
so many items.
You don't see Alistair's get this late. Okay, they're fighting.
All right, we're flashing in. It only lands onto Doran. Mom doesn't really do too much either. Zekka, he goes in and then he goes back out again. And now both teams sort of hitting the dragon. No one really finding purchase in this team fight. Headbutt. Just by itself.
Wait, in before Piosik ults Sejuani again.
Doesn't necessarily know whether he wants to stay in. Zekka lost too much health. You have to back away. It's time to give up this one. Oh, Delight gets into the back line. He dives on top of Perfect as BDD. He's going to go in as well. Beryl is now in amongst it, but he's so tanky. This is just
Who did Piosik ult?
Beryl is now in amongst it, but he's so tanky.
This is just absurd.
All right, he ulted the. He ulted the Yone, but the Yone was already in ult animation.
He's going to go in as well. Beryl is now in amongst it, but he's so tanky. This is just.
Watch Zekka. So he actually does ult the Yone, but the Yone is already in ult animation onto Deft. Rip, and Deft doesn't flash it. It's okay. Yes, GA. Yeah, well, the GA didn't work in this case. That's so unlucky, guys. Look at this. He cues the Sejuani, and then he ults Zekka, but Zekka's already in his Yone ult animation. Viper just tossing out Chains of Corruption again. Holy shit. Viper just in bullet hell at the back, dodging fucking Smolder sneezes. It's actually crazy that they only lost Pioshik in that entire engagement. How did he even get in range to ult Yone? He walked up. He's literally watch him. Pioshik is right here. He cues in. He sees Zekka coming in. Zekka's soul unbound. And then he ults. This is his ult right here. He's going up, right? But the ult animation has already started, so he gets the ult into the back line. Def should have flashed that. I think if Def flashes Yone ult, they legit win that fight. That's what I think. Like, he should be able to flash that. Because, like, look how much damage he's doing at 1 HP, guys. Imagine if he was still full HP. They just win this fight. BDD zoned his own team off. I mean, I don't think that's the biggest thing right here, because Alistar has ult and he doesn't want the follow up from the Rakan ult is why he ults right there. So he actually prevents the follow up from HLE, I think, on Delight's ult, right? Because Beryl is also in there zoning out. Not sure they could walk up on that one anyway. You got the over 100k gold though.
And Honolife Esports managed to take out the 600 CS Smolder.
This is the most ridiculous game of the season.
It's a fun game though, guys. This was a really fun game to watch.
The ultra late game 55 minute victory. Smolder with 600 CS.
Yeah, the wall wasn't great, guys, but I think the real thing there is that they didn't actually flash the Yone ult. I think if he flashes that Yone ult, like, they just hard win the fight and then they win the game.
Man, I don't even know what to say. Like, the way that game ended, the sheer chaos at that dragon fight.
Zonado, thank you for the Twitch Prime sub.
If you look at how low everyone's health was, that was the deal breaker.
Yeah.
If we saw...
55-minute game reminds me of Season 3.
Instantly, everyone just pops.
They're just over.
Although, I mean, it was just basically an Eldaroth,
right? Yeah. Because Humble Esports, they got an Elder, and Deft was Elder. So I guess, like, there were executes on both sides.
Yep.
Just constantly in effect. What? Wow. Well, Humble Esports, they will take game number one, which kind of just tracks.
Do you think League would be more interesting if a coach could be in comms during game? No. I think you have to have let the players call. Having a coach in there who just sits there and calls would make the game super weird.
Don't vote for the Varus, because that's a boom boom damage.
That was a fun game though, guys. That was really fun.
No one remembers that. You know, you just have to look for the next game reset. Like, okay, 1-0 down, that's fine. Let's re-examine. Maybe Death will take cut down this time.
I don't know whether you necessarily can take.
All right, on to game two, guys.
Run it back. Maokai is still open and available.
This time we're actually just going to straight up ban Smolder, says Hanwha. Ash is up. Maokai is up as well. We're going to pick Ash here. Yes, we are. Ash and Sejuani. So they're afraid of the Sejuani-Yone mid lane combo again. Going to take Jin into Ash, probably so they don't actually take Ash-Jin, which is incredibly annoying. So we will take the Cassante for Perfect, who has been a bit of a Cassante merchant, it has to be said.
Definitely be over quick. Well, Gwen is up and available.
Gwen
so
is up and available.
They can just play that.
We haven't seen it as much recently, but it is a matchup we often saw into the Cassante. Kind of crazy that Talia got left open again.
It was almost really fun.
I mean, it's fair. I think KT is getting everything they want here. Look at the non-committal engage they have. They have Ash Arrow. They have Sejuani. So it feels really strong. Really strong, right? Yeah, the Sejuani doesn't have the best synergy with the solo lanes, but we can forgive that.
It still could be picked because it's really
just build 19. Good at it.
Yeah.
Rakan back for Delight again, and we are going to take the Udyr. So Udyr and Cassante were banned because those have been Perfect champions last game. They both get left up by Hanwha this time around. Oh, we're going to take Sivir Ashe. This is the top esports comp.
Going to pick it up. So
anybody, hopefully the casters know about the top esports Sivir Ashe combo that was used with Jackie Love on the Sivir.
Against the Rakan, good against Yone, but also just the amount of melee champions on the side of Humble Life Esports, so much value on a Sivir to Leah. You're just doing so much damage when they're clumped up together. So KT, obviously planning to go late stages. Deft, you better have cut down this game.
Nope. Yeah. Okay. Well, let's talk about what Sivir Ashe does. Top Esports ran this combo against Weibo in game two of their series recently. Obviously gives you super good wave clear with the Sivir. You have the spell shield to stop Rakan engages onto you or possibly Jin Ws. But this is really a pick comp, guys. Remember a couple years ago, year and a half ago, we used to see T1 running Sivir, and it wasn't for team fighting. I think people think Sivir, and because of all of her AoE damage, they think that she can only be used in team fights. In fact, you can just pop ult and collapse on one side of a flank really easily and use her speed to create picks. Now, you combine that with Sejuani R, Talia R, basically able to reposition, Ashe R, and also Cassante isolation. This is a really big pick composition, is how it should be used. Like, they should have total control over objectives because they should be able to, if anybody tries to flank them, they should be able to pick that person off before Hanwha can respond at all. Right? And they also should be able to intercept anybody coming to objectives really easily. This is I'm actually surprised because this composition looks like something that T1 should be running. Jin is not awful right now. Lethality Jin can be quite strong.
Some choices were made itemization wise. I prefer to look at the gameplay. yeah. You know, rather than that.
Well, the only reason I'm damage.
I want to assume the amount of damage that would have done. Yeah. It would have been absolutely ridiculous. Plus, there's a threshold of the amount of health you can get to. The value of that goes through the roof.
Yeah.
So that would have been a decent lead. And KT fans need to be a little bit quieter.
Yeah.
I'm a bit nervous.
Well,
you know, because I won three games.
You all know why they lost game one. They were too.
Because Rakan had Smite.
Yeah.
And Guardian. He didn't. He just did 45 damage with a grand entrance.
That's all you need to do.
I actually thought that I'd miss.
What do you use to draw on screen? It's a program called Epic Pen.
I think because what happened is that I'm pretty sure they put Piosik into his GA and then they all just hit the back. Everyone was like, everyone just hit Dragon and we'll just
see what happens.
Hopefully kill it.
Yeah.
And it worked. So, you know, good stuff. And this game, yeah, I feel like the Jhin is going to struggle. It's going to get to the point where I think they focus the Yone and the Jhin trying to cut through Sejuani Cassante is going to have a bad time.
But I also, we said that about Lethality Varus in the last game.
There was less tanks in the last game, to be fair. There was an Aatrox, there was a Vi, you know. The Alistar was tanky, but I feel like these are like super tanks, you know, not just bruises.
Yeah, very true. And they barely even really had much of a tank last time around. As Doran just says goodbye to Perfect.
Alistar was like the tankiest one they had last time.
He was. I guess Vi, somewhat. But Beryl getting aggressive. Pretty cool skin.
Imagine just what like a whiplash it is going from playing like Alistar in a like hour-long game and then playing Ash. Just
it must feel good though, because Alistar, I feel like in the late game you have a lot of agency. You're constantly looking for angles, but in the early laning phase you have zero.
Yeah.
And so going from playing Alistar to playing Alistar is actually the biggest whiplash, because you actually have zero agency at this stage of the game. But yep. Now he's Ash, all of the agency in the laning phase.
Now you can do stuff and right click and
yeah, and he is gonna do that.
And they're just gonna have
yeah, I'm over Cassante being in every game at this point too, guys.
I don't think there's a point where like
and we have to wait until what 14-4 when he might be nerfed enough. We'll see.
With an Alistar lane,
which says a lot.
Yeah. Zekka is still having an okay time up against BDD in this lane.
Yeah, I feel like they practiced as much recently.
Yeah.
In the last hour.
Bit of deja vu. As Piosik is getting hit by...
Oh, Udyr, you're such a piece of shit, champ.
I have no idea.
Okay, let's look at this. So he actually does have a ward there that he placed in earlier. So if we go back, this is his ward that he puts at the start of the game, just so he can do this. He wants to push with R. You'll notice the timing, too. He's doing this right as the waves crash so that he can maximize his time without losing really any CS or experience. And so he can pay careful attention to the jungle path here, does start pushing up, pushes up at 2:30, knows that, you know, the Sejuani's going to be crossing up at approximately that time. Gets seen, he sees the Raptors, so he has perfect timing. I mean, this is very well played by Doran.
Yeah, I feel like they practiced as much recently.
Yeah.
This is something you guys can do as blue side Udyrs and solo queue, by the way. Because junglers typically path bot to top in solo queue, get a leash from the bot lane. And so in that circumstance, super easy to get your ward in early and then be a giant douche like this.
It looked weird because he was like stalling, but trust me, when there's a big Udyr stand.
Yeah, he couldn't click the blast cone.
Yeah, you can't click that.
Threw him in to hit the blast cone.
Yeah.
So he was like, just take this time. Make
he was dissecting
it.
Pixels.
Yeah,
at that point in time.
He got the cone and didn't just auto Doran, because then I think he might have actually died.
Yep. Well, speaking of Doran, he is back into the lane once again.
Yeah, Doran just being irritating.
He is. I guess that is the Udyr way.
Yeah.
Our players really just constantly finding new ways to make Udyr look way more useful than he has any right to be.
Yeah. Oh, Peanut walking mid with the light. You know, that actually potentially could have been a good play, right? The flash route from Peanut, the knock-up, the follow-up.
Kind of looked like a fashion runway more than anything else. They just sort of walked up and then they both walked back down at the same time. Not really too much more happening as Pioshik is going to be able to do a little bit of damage to Delight here. Viper also going to be spotted out as Beryl just getting ready to throw a volley at him. And Delight
Wait,
has...
Wait, you think Beryl playing Ashe is going to throw a volley?
He did manage to get the experience. Yeah, no, I made that assumption.
Yeah, that's a bold one to make, but yeah. Looks like it paid off.
Well, all of my assumptions in the last game didn't pay off at all, so I'm throwing Hail Marys now.
No, they really didn't.
It was bad news. All right, Delight and Viper back in lane. Zekka not having the greatest of times. Perfect having a worse time, though, as we can see. Kasante, oh my god. Every time, it brings up these stats in exactly the wrong time.
Yeah, it's showing it. It's being like, by the way, Kasante normally wins this matchup pretty much every time. And as you're seeing that Perfect's getting smacked, you're like, oh.
Yeah.
Well, that says a lot.
I think one of my water bottles is leaking, by the way. There's a lot of water on the desk.
Oh.
That doesn't bode well for the fact that this game is probably going to go to 75 minutes.
Yeah, good thing you got a spare.
Yeah. But one spare, I had one for the last series as well. That was done in like 30 minutes.
Oh.
Then I had that much time again. Oh dear. Well, I probably shouldn't be talking about that because there is a video game to be played as Homolife Esports are going to take some grubs. Looking to stick around and grab all of them as well. I think having the extra pushing power is a good idea.
Yeah, got the early presence from the UDA to help out with that. You deny Kiosik from having one and actually...
Free grubs at 5 minutes. Feels super good.
Because Doran invaded Kiosik, it's actually a decent amount behind. Obviously, the Krogs are a factor as well, but still level 4 to Penis level 5 right now.
All right. Well, he's throwing some rocks around. And
been doing
Zekka,
a lot of that recently.
Yeah. He's pretty good at it. Zekka also good at unbinding his soul.
Oh, and this is a terrible spot for the wave to be in.
Zekka has to carry his comp. They're low damage. Yeah, but here's the thing. You know, they have a lot of pressure with this Udyr, so if they play well around Udyr pressure and they can get some pickoffs, like the Yone pick potential with the Jhin, with a long-range W or Jhin ult, could be pretty huge. I agree, though, if you go into late game, it's pretty easy to itemize armor and potentially win against this composition. And KT really should be playing around pick potential, right? But Sivir not 6 yet, Ashe not 6 yet, Taliyah just hit 6.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely still is.
It's pretty cool that it is. But
I think it's crazy. They think they can just change the names of abilities and we're gonna...
Yeah, like Pillar of Filth, am I right?
Yeah.
Pillar of Ice, yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
No way I'm ever saying that. Pillar of Filth.
Yeah, Pillar of Filth was so much better. Or as we used to call it back in the OG days of League, Shit Dildo. I miss Shit Dildo, guys. Ice Dildo, not as fun.
That's fine.
Has anyone asked Udyr if he wanted to change the name of his abilities?
Definitely not.
Definitely not Udyr?
Yeah, it's true. The Udyr does do some decent magic damage. Maokai will deal some amount of magic damage as well. I miss old Trundle. He was gross.
And KT, I'm a little bit worried for them because I do feel like they're not playing with the same amount of gusto.
Shit Dildo not as hygienic? Yeah, that's why Trundle wanted to fuck you with it. He wasn't doing it to be nice.
KT kind of did a lot of chilling in the last game until they hit stacks, and if we're speaking...
He was using biological warfare against you.
We all know that...
Yeah, Sivir pretty good at...
400 CS win con.
Yeah.
You know, so they could just lean towards that.
And if Teddy had anything to say about it, it's 1500 CS.
Yeah, and then so they do that, and then they get to the late game, and we're like, oh, well, they're looking pretty good, and then they lose. That's kind of how the last game went. So if that's the game plan, they could run it back.
Tell you what, Deft and Barrel.
I miss Cigar Graves. Yep. Gragas allowed to be a word slurring, absurd alcoholic, but Graves not able to quietly smoke his cigar.
Shield like we were talking about, and Beryl hailing his blades onto Viper, who takes a large amount of damage.
That's because people have now decided for you which are the socially appropriate ways to destroy your body and poison yourself, and which are not. And it is socially acceptable to poison yourself with alcohol, but it is not no longer socially acceptable to poison yourself with tobacco, guys. That's what society tells us. Society decides which drugs you can use.
Like normally the play for Maokai, you walk bot, you
Thanks, China. I don't think China had anything to do with that, by the way, guys. Everybody smokes in China. If anything, tobacco is more culturally appropriate in Asia. That feels, if you had to ask me, guys, saying tobacco isn't culturally appropriate feels like a California move. That feels like a California move. That doesn't feel like an Asia move. They change the splash art first in China. Who knows?
Maybe we can have our latest first blood. Where's that? That's I think I've got that stat in front of me.
Oh, yeah.
Latest first blood. 21 minutes? Is it 21 minutes?
Maybe.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, let's just go with that.
21 minutes. So
let's
we need
to see if it's long.
Got another 10 minutes.
Stop.
This is looking too aggressive. Looking a bit too aggressive.
Guys,
clear out of control ward. Oh, Zeka's on the roam.
How is it dangerous? Stay away from him. Remember when you get
Death once again. Showing the value of a spell shield, yeah?
Yep.
I just find it hilarious that society has decided that tobacco is where we draw the line, guys. And we just don't do it with alcohol. Now, I'm in favor of both of these things being legal. You know what I mean? But it's like, what is the difference? Oh, so tobacco is addictive. Well, so is alcohol. The difference is nobody, like, you can die from overconsumption of tobacco. Oh, you could die from overconsumption of alcohol. Oh, consuming enough alcohol can cause cancer just like tobacco. The difference is, though, is that nobody got so fucked up on tobacco that they, like, you know, got in a fight or something like that. Secondhand smoking sucks. Just have people do it outside. What's the problem? Just say you can't do it inside.
It like tells you, like, towers are dangerous. Get away.
Yeah.
Just need that.
And then is that what?
The social aspect of drinking? Dude, the social aspect of smoking. Ask any Middle Eastern person about the social aspects of smoking, guys.
Delight's fine, and now Barrel has to flash. He immediately gets out of there. The curtain call comes in, and Zeka doesn't quite find an angle.
Yeah, just unfortunately,
oh, he's on a ward.
Death wasn't able to connect onto Delight. They just lacked the damage.
Tobacco is more addictive. Of course it is more addictive than weed.
We're still on track. 10 minutes. Let's go.
10 minutes to go.
Latest.
Here's the problem, though. It's a Chemtech Dragon second. Does that mean
yeah, smoke breaks so big in Korea. True that.
Something, you know, for the team that gets the soul.
Yeah,
kind of crazy.
Not gonna lie, during that previous game, there's definitely points I forgot.
Anyway, I just think it's funny.
I didn't even realize they had it the whole game. I think.
Yeah.
Graves can't have a cigar. In the end.
We get an earth wind. Oh no, we can't get earth, wind, and fire unless it's like toxic wind. Earth, toxic wind, and fire. Because then we get the like little feathers and stuff all over the place. The cinders.
Oh, I mean,
that'd be really dope.
Always want to have the Infernal Rift. It is
so
most fun. And the thing is, you know what feels nice? Is that Maokai used to get absolutely...
Yeah, the 30 CS jungle gap is crazy.
Destroyed all the brushes, so...
Yeah.
Bioshik having a rough time.
That's not a thing. So
he's been trying to pressure the bot side, though.
It's great. And it also sort of works out because he also likes... I like the Burning Tree Maokai as well.
Yeah.
But the fact that he hated the Infernal Rift so much felt like I should never actually pick that skin because it feels like I'm asking for trouble.
Yeah,
you know? It's not so good. So perfect now with a couple...
Yeah, by the way, that's a good point. Graves can't have a cigar. He can have a huge shotgun. So let's be clear. Graves is outside on Summoner's Rift smoking a cigar, causing no harm to anyone but himself through his act of smoking. And yet... it is acceptable for him to just run around the rift, shooting people in the face with a shotgun. That's acceptable, but he can't smoke outside.
Magic resist components feeling a little bit better. As okay, Peanut and Viper doing a fair bit of work here. Seismic Shove is trying to help Pyoshik out, but he's going down so low. Magic resist components feeling a little bit better. As okay, Peanut and Viper. Viper doing a fair bit of work here. Seismic Shove is trying to help Pyoshik out, but he's going down so low, and there is first blood.
It's actually crazy. So first off, that we get a 12-minute first blood, but then also this is the play that does it when BDD is literally right there and Zekka is in lane. The WQ, Rakan ultimate flashes. Viper actually flashes for that. Very slow first blood.
Too much CC layered, and Pyosik wasn't able to get out because of the blocking from Peanut. Second dragon gonna be secured by Hanwha Esports. And
all right, Zekka not able to find Beryl there as a teleport is coming in. In comes PDD as well. They don't have a smite, so it's not for the dragon as Doran gets over to try and meet them here as the curtain call, getting a lot of value. Viper doesn't really throw it the last bullet at Perfect very much, who doesn't find a Q either. And so it looks like
I can't believe Hanwha get away with this heist, by the way, because they have no ults. Like, they have no engage ults anymore. They have no Rakan ult, they have no Maokai ult after that pickoff. Where is this arrow used? The arrow gets used super late on a Viper, but he just cleanses it. So and Viper has no sums. And they still have Sivir ult too. BDD just doesn't feel like using wall. This is so badly done, by the way. PDD goes all the way around here because he's scared of walking into his jungle after that, but he doesn't immediately go and try and box them in with wall while he knows Cassante TP is up. This is such a wacky-ass split call, guys. These guys should not allowed to get out of this situation. They had nothing.
So it looks like I'm alive, able to just get out of there.
They had nothing.
Take themselves the Drake, and they will move.
They just gave it up for free and just used TP and Ghost onto Cassante.
I mean, there's a lot of tanks, so it's going to be very hard to kill the Ocean Soul, but yeah, definitely not.
That feels like less...
less fun.
Yeah, less decisiveness.
But also, we're going to have a situation where more brush for Peanut to throw sapling.
Oh, true. So much better for Peanut.
Yeah, Peanut's liking it.
Yeah.
But yeah, two dragons already down. I feel like Conan Life Esports a little bit low roll, getting the Ocean Soul instead of some of the other strong ones, but still would be looking to secure that one. And I feel like there, the setup kind of ended up being okay for KT with them all trapped in the pit, but Death just doesn't have enough damage yet.
No.
I think he needs like three or four items before he's really just cutting through Conan Life Esports.
Yeah, it's going to go, I assume, Quick Blades next, and then hopefully into something like
Ocean insane here, yes. Ocean is really insane. Extremely annoying on Yone, Udyr, and Maokai. Extremely annoying.
You know, maybe it is Blades. Maybe that makes more sense. It just, I don't know, it's just the build path, because normally if you go like Crit Cloak to Longsword, it's because you're going LDR because the build path is so bad.
Ah, right.
But we'll see. Maybe he just...
Seeing a Crit Cloak in an inventory is not exactly a feels great situation.
Yeah. No one really wants to do that to themselves.
No. Deft has opted in, though. We do have an extra level on a Weaver's Wall. Is okay, Feral may just be dead. Zekka throwing out a combo, but is going to go back. Pyoshik also now potentially in trouble.
Pyoshik.
Extra level on a Weaver's Wall. Is okay, Feral may just be dead.
So Beryl... Beryl gets almost 100 to 0, has to use ult, and Pyoshik is still standing there walking forward. Pyoshik is such a fucking fraud, dude. Have you seen the way he's played these two games?
By the Djinn at the same time. Seismic Shove to throw him back, but BDD was already punched over there, and Hanwha Life Esports 5-0 in the early game, and it really does feel like this is not the same KT from game one.
Just a catastrophic failure. Pyosi completely caught off guard, whiff seal completely, and Hanwha...
What the fuck, man? What is he doing? He literally sees Beryl almost die, and then he walks forward into the Krug pit, and then he's like surprised when the fucking Yone comes over the wall, and then completely whiffs his ult. He misses his ult because Zekka ults over the top of him.
And that is going to be a big advantage. Beryl actually slowed down as the curtain call is going to be blocked there by Depp. Grand entrance, and Beryl's taken down by Delight. And now he's chasing down BDD and Depp. And in comes Peanut. Depp nowhere to go.
And their pick comp is just never going to work like this.
We do have an extra level on a Weaver's wall.
What are we even doing in here? You don't see any of them. Like, you literally see Vision right here. Look. You know, you literally see their vision. This is KT's vision. BDD is in the bot side, and you're just walking up, wasting your Ash ult at point blank range.
Now potentially in trouble. A lot of KT members just hanging out with all of Hum Alive, and that is going to be a big advantage. Beryl actually slowed down as the curtain call is going to be blocked there by Depth.
Nice engage though by Delight.
Taken down by Delight, and now he's chasing down BDD and Deft, and in comes Peanut. Deft nowhere.
Sivirul just thrown away because the Maokai ult was there on the flank.
Seismic shove to throw him back, but BDD was already punched over there, and Hum Alive Esports 5-0 in the early game. And it really does.
I convinced my soon to be wife to name our first daughter Talia. Unfortunately, she didn't want to name our first boy Not or Cho'Gath.
Hum Alive Esports just capitalized. Peanut's able to come down and punish, and come on, Peanut.
Showing some driving. Swings around.
Oh,
gets on in there. There's the knock up on the Beryl as well. The cat is down. The flash forward, and there's the kill. That's just a solo from Zekka. They'll take down this turret at the same time, and KT cannot keep up with this pace.
I've got to say, Hum Alive Esports have shown such a massive improvement from the last time Peanut drove a Rift Herald. It's very clear they've been practicing.
It's absolutely true.
Yeah, it's just
Deft is a good name for a boy.
This plays a little bit tentative.
Sure, why not?
Going this aggressive here? I don't know. I'm like, Beryl's already so low. Just back away. He ends up overcoming the ult.
The ult is
so bad, guys.
And the thing is,
like, you literally need to get vision so you can create the picks that you want for your composition. You can't just walk into a dark jungle. You need to get the vision.
Slowing down Anudia. Oh, hitting him with an ultimate. That's a way to do it. And Permafrost is going to be there, but Deft is delivered a kill. So they're on the board. KT have found one, but there's still 6,000 gold behind.
Oh, it is going to be the Navori.
That's going to be the second choice. As BDD misses a cannon, it's all going wrong for KT.
Yeah, not going too well at the moment. It's such a... It's already like a 5,000 gold lead the side of Hum Alive.
Is Jin Rakan good? I don't think it's particularly good. It's good in this sense because KT keeps running into it and getting picked off.
Yeah, Doran demolished the turret, and then Asante did things, and then Doran ran away.
Yep, and then Beryl hit the ult, and that was it.
Yeah.
And they gave the kill to Depth, which I'm going to go with saying was a smart move.
Yeah, I think it's good to give a bit of extra money to...
As game is over, like, they're just going to get Ocean Soul and just grind out these fights.
I can finish the Vori, great. Need an LDR. Hence your fourth item on top of that before you're really pumping damage. BDD is going to need Leandres and possibly Crypt Bloom, but then also might go for an early Zhonya's because of the Rakan... Yone threat, so this feels like less like game one where like, okay, they're scaling for the Smolder win con because that's what they want to do, and this is more like they're just kind of holding on until they have a position they can actually fight. Through this deficit, I don't think you'll fight this dragon.
Well, they're at least in the area. BDD does have...
Maybe they'll just commit suicide. By the way, the pick comp cannot fight this fight once they're already on dragon. You have to get vision and catch them in the rotation, catch somebody out. Or you have to start the Drake and then collapse if they try on one flank, if they try and flank you.
That's a lot of danger, but perfect
with Sivirul.
Throw Zekka around. Phenomenal snipe there with the seismic shove. As now Peanut is completely out of this pit. He gets back in though. Twisted advance to close the distance on the dragon. As now Peanut gets into the back line. Peanut once again is out of the pit as Doran is tanking for forever. These fights are going so long.
I can't believe KT wins this. Holy shit. That's unbelievable.
Delight unseen right now. As Goshik gonna get knocked up. He's the jungler. That's a lot of danger, but perfect is gonna be.
They actually do a very good job of getting Zekka. The fact that Zekka dies first here, this is really well played by KT. Wow. So BDD knows where he is because he sees him come over the dragon wall, so he knows that his body is there as he does Soul Unbound, and he just gets absolutely CC smoked as he comes into this fight. Peanut also doesn't use ult. Like, why is he... What is with the junglers ulting in this series? Why is he waiting to ult? He should be ulting here as Yone goes in, one would think. Right? He's got such a good ult angle. He's probably waiting for, you know, the Drake to go down a little lower so he can prevent the engage. But if Zekka's going in, you have to ult, man. You have to ult. And BDD just has the EW ready for him when he gets back into pit. That's so good. I think he does that blind. Right? Because they have a pink ward in the pit. There's no vision inside the pit, right? I think he does this blind. Yeah, I don't know why Mao didn't ult when the Yone went in. It's so fucking weird. He saw him snack back? Okay, fair enough. I mean, it's... He can see the line of the snapback, right? But that's still pretty impressive that he manages to get that kill. You can see the tether. It's really well played, though.
These fights are going so long, but finally KT are able to come out ahead. And that is all to do with BDD being the maestro of these. He gets back up. He's the jungler. That's a lot of danger, but perfect is going to be.
I mean, that's very impressive, guys. And the fact that BDD is even there. I just don't understand what Peanut was waiting for with the ult. Now, typically, the thing is, typically you would wait for the Drake to get low and you use the Maokai ult to prevent the jungler from getting in smite range, right? But in this case, when Zekka goes over the wall, you just kind of have to commit. He's got a great angle for the Maokai ult. Instead, he throws a sapling into the brush, watches this fucking Yone get giga dumpstered, and then Yone just dies on the snapback. So weird. You know, Viper also has ult here. So, like, you would think he would pop ult as Yone goes in, too. Right here. I think Zekka just went in, man. I think his team just didn't realize he was trying to engage. See, BDD has been the second best mid in LCK. I mean, he's top three.
Oh my god. Nearly actually. That is not. That. The maestro of the team fight. A 5,000 gold deficit.
He's standing on the scuttle crab, guys.
Oh my god. Nearly
actually. Lethality Jhin is no joke.
Look, that line. Deft was in front, all right? If Beryl's complaining. That looked to me like it was right.
I think Beryl is taller than Death, maybe? Or maybe Death, like, kneeled down.
Broader shoulders?
Yeah, I don't know. But a 5,000 gold deficit in KT...
Were your top three, Trovi, Faker, BDD?
So perfect. You see Zekka go in and immediately the focus is on him. Beautiful job peeling here.
I don't know why Zekka goes in. I don't know why Zekka goes in. They should have just been doing the Drake, guys. They should have just been doing the Drake. He is supposed to be there for counter engage. If they start walking up, you Maokai ult them, and then you put Yone out. Zekka really is the most responsible for that because his team was not expecting it. and he just got himself CC'd to death. That was badly done.
Oh, I thought he was going to make a comment about it, but he didn't.
Yeah, I probably would have said, like, ow, that hit.
Yeah.
In ultra.
Because he was that little bit just to the side.
Yeah.
But it was very nicely played there by Viper to make sure that he nailed it, even if it didn't actually mean anything at all.
Then he did. Like, especially when, I'm not sure if you had the LDR there, but especially going LDR second, like, if you had a...
LDR, yeah. Okay, so KT, pseudo, still 3,000 gold behind. That analogy was terrible, but it's getting late. The last game honestly did a decent job of breaking me.
Yep, and if this is a long one, and then we have a game three, man, we're in the long...
Invest. The ultimate, Def able to eat it. Arrow is going to stop Viper, as now Zekka tries to get in. That dodge from Def looked so dangerous, but he was avoiding...
Now he's just a Baron. They don't have Maokai ult.
But it is just that.
Yep, a lot of things thrown at Deft and Barrel, but they managed to avoid it. They also used the Hawk shot just to verify Baron isn't being started. We saw Zekka stacking up his tornado on it, but nothing else. And now the big thing is KT once again deny away the stacking dragons, so they have more time.
Yeah.
They have more time before Soul is on the cards. As much as Ocean Soul isn't the strongest Soul, I do think cutting through the bulky, like a Cassante with Ocean Soul, sounds pretty nasty.
I was gonna say, like, could you imagine if Homolife Esports get...
Dude, the Yone with the Ocean Soul is so annoying.
Ocean Soul, and then we just watch Doran and
Maokai also just super annoying with that.
What happens?
These tanks that can just live forever.
Nothing at all. Just forever. Forever nothing.
Yeah, and we've seen BDD go for the Leandre second, so not opting to cut into his build, cut down the damage, and pick up a... Seekers. I mean, obviously the threat is there from the side of Honolife Esports, but I think with the front line that they have, you need the damage. And I think, honestly, I can see you just going Leandre's into Crypt Loom.
Well, look at this. Doran still had his fucking Rift Herald recall. What? At 22 minutes? 23 minutes into this game, he still had his Rift Herald recall?
Yes. Well, Leandre's has now been completed. I think was his third item last time around as well. 2,000 gold,
I believe. Talia is great, man. I think Talia is just giga broken, especially on this patch with the buffs that she got to E and Q. Makes it even better in jungle, in mid lane, is a flex pick. I think she sucks. You are wrong. She plays so well into so many matchups right now. She changes the way the enemy team plays the game. She changes the way the enemy team drafts. It's very annoying.
As well, considering the advantage that he does have, Yoshik could potentially be in trouble as Doran and Delight are chasing after him, but neither of them really do too much as far as damage to this Sejuani.
Team should not play Anivia instead. Talia is much better. Talia can affect the map in very profound ways. The problem is that KT is just playing badly on the map right now. I mean, the range of her ult once she hits 16 is so crazy. It makes it very difficult to split push. And you can get objectives for free, just like you can with Poppy. But again, KT here, they don't have any priority over the Drake, which makes it very hard to operate their pick composition, basically. And if Zekka doesn't throw the game this time... There you go. There's the right Maokai ult this time. Yes, secure. Easy. Now you go in. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. Doesn't matter that you hit the Jhin with the arrow. He already used his ult. Okay, just get out. Yep. Very good. Much better from Hanwha. Much better.
Yeah, it felt like Piosik didn't want to sacrifice himself to get the dragon. You know, he could have queued into the pit earlier, but he knew there's a good chance he goes down. If he does, doesn't want to be dead for Baron. The Maokai ult is enough to keep him at bay. And now they're kind of just fishing at the moment. And I got to say, Piosik doesn't feel that tanky yet. I think part of the reason he's also investing into MR.
Mixed, like, magic damage from Moody, right?
Yeah, I mean, I think a Rukin in your build isn't a bad thing. But
maybe build a Sunfire Cape, like finish it first or something?
Yeah, or just build like another armor item and then... Yeah. But the problem with junglers in pro play... Oh.
Yoshik is just going to get smashed back here, comboed forever, and Beryl is the target. Or something?
Yeah, or just build like another armor item and then... Yeah. But the problem with junglers in pro play... Oh.
Yoshik has no ults, so Yoshik has no ults. Does he not have Q? Why does he just leave? Wow, gets the kill after Beryl's flash too.
Somehow Pyoshik actually survives and now has a friend to try and keep him safe. It's not going to work out as Peanut happily underneath the turret, and now Delight gets in there.
Wow, nice job by Delight.
He has to flash Deft as well. He's so low as Viper. So aggressive.
Here we go.
Now BDD, he is likely to fall, but he does get the shield there from Perfect all out, but it's just
the Udyr just running at the Sivir.
As Zekker is going to be able to kill him. And now Homolife Esports, this could be just a massive amount of turrets. The gold advantage is going to balloon to high heaven.
Yeah, and they should just be able to go for the Baron. I mean, Pyosik had such a good week last week.
KT looks so... They look terrible in these games, guys. Even that Smolder game last time, they couldn't actually just fucking peel to save their life. Pyosik has had such a bad series. This is it's classic Pyosik, man.
Definitely not.
That's a bad play.
And tick, 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 boom. So we're going to check out the replay here, and this was just...
Where was Sedge's Q?
Yeah.
That was
just off the back of being the one...
Oh, it just skipped forward randomly?
They both took it. That's a bad play, if I'm going to be honest. One person or the other, the fact they both managed to get connected on it, a little bit unfortunate. And here, Def doing everything he can to survive. But when this Udyr comes at you, like, there's no referee. He ults, he flashes. Guys...
Yeah, you're normally like, well, I'm underneath my turret, so I should be fine, aren't I? No. No, you're not.
It's Doran's turret now.
It is. And he's going to be able to take that inner, but they took the Baron as well. 8,000 gold is now the lead, and
this
2 minutes
the
on the soul.
2-0 Genji.
Yeah. And they managed to survive for 55 minutes in the last game as well.
And they
even that's looking relatively amazing at this point.
I mean, they are 7,000 gold behind. It's a...
Another to respond to the Ernst hitting them like Deft will have some wave clear, but not as much against this Baron as Viper just hitting them like fish in a barrel. In goes Zekka once again, and Beryl just cannot do any wave clear.
I just this Ashe getting assassinated from like half the map away is so funny. I mean, he flashes for this, right? Gets the knock up and then just cleaves him to pieces.
Tries to keep them safe, but Delight finds him, gets into that backline. Perfect is just trying to peel, but Doran is almost unpeelable. BDD standing in front of the bullets. Deft is still alive for the minute, and so is Perfect. He's pretty dangerous. They managed to get a Q to pull them back, but this is 28 minutes into the game. These down these Nexus turrets, the inhibitor to go down first. One Nexus turret falls. Are Homolife Esports just going to do it now, or are they going to look for a reset, grab themselves a soul, and then go for the end?
They've got so much gold in their pockets, they've done so much damage here for the long run. They want this game done fast. You can see here, they go...
Perfect is very, very tanky, but I don't think it's going to be enough as Beryl! Oh, God!
Watching Beryl just get one-shot by this Yasuo every time is so funny, or the Yone, rather, is so funny. Poor Beryl.
Not pretty good one for the action. Now they're looking to end the game.
All right. Zekka looking for some knockouts.
Oh, man. I hope you guys didn't actually believe that KT wasn't fraudulent, by the way. I hope you weren't those KT believers.
I don't know whether that might be biting off more than he can chew, but the Nexus, that is not going to be much.
I hope you weren't the KT believers, everybody. Because you know what KT always is? We all know what they are. Guys got razor caked again, believing in KT.
He was dancing at the end of the first.
Got the context.
I missed the context.
And we got it. Yeah, I mean, I think...
And
I will never believe a team with Pyosik and Beryl on it aren't blatant frauds. Yes, Violet Cats, I agree. Watch the first minute of the space. Okay.
Skoko on the Korean side. All of us predicted KT, but they got stomped today. What went wrong?
We should have known the moment all of us predicted KT.
So I guess Cadrel was right. I guess Monty was right. I guess KT is fraudulent. I thought, after the Gen.G win, the clean plays we saw, Pioshi getting OPG.
Looked so good. He had a 9.8 out of 10.
I was ready to trust, you know? Now the telecom war is ruined! And they took game one away, and game two was not even a game, and the players were not coordinated at all, and it was just a wash. And I wanted to see, I want to have four strong teams in the LCK that I could trust. I want four. I want KT, Hanwha Life to join, Gen.G and T1. Maybe it's going to be Kwangdong. Maybe
yes, Wolf, it's Kwangdong. Kwangdong's the real team, Wolf. I'm telling you, Kwangdong's the real team.
I just want to make the very clear before.
I'm not even a KT fan. I just want him to be good. I just wanted to be consistent. I want to know what we're going to get. I want to know when KT shows up. This is what I can see. This is what I'm going to experience. Not just a, is it good KT today or bad KT or mediocre KT or excellent KT?
Atlas tried to tell you.
I mean, I know, but it
still hurts.
At some point, the team has to find its footing completely and not boom us again and again and again and again and again. They should have gone to the finals in summer. You know, you go all the way back.
They should have. I agree.
Every time.
Even though that was only two of these players.
Maybe they definitely over it. Yeah, definitely. It seems that way. Maybe they just get sixth in summer and then they go on and win worlds. We'll see. We did have a draft in that game.
We did have a draft. All right, guys. LPL time. Time for some top esports, the team that can win with Sivir and Ashe. Gotta turn down the Chinese counter a little bit. Alright guys, bathroom break for me, see you in a couple. All right. So, yes, LWX is not playing right now, guys. LP, formerly the bot laner in spring of LNG, until they got Gala from RNG. What do you think is a Denver native that Jokic plays League? I think it's funny that he plays Illaoi and Urgot. In top lane. I don't think much of it, though. I'm not really a basketball fan, so. So I guess they're still on 14.2 because we have a Nico ban. When do they actually switch to 14.3? I guess it'll be next week. All right, Ash first pick. Zero surprises. Nautilus ban, a bit interesting. Usually we just see it get picked, not actually exit the ban phase, but particularly since Varus is still up. And you might want to take not Varus, K, Orianna, and Azir trade, and skirmishing junglers, hiding Rell till R5. Ban Draven and Ezreal just as champions to be paired with Ash here. That could be annoying. So we're going to see. Oh, they're doing it. The top esports comp, Sivir Ashe. Okay. Extremely strong engage. Opt into the Aatrox Kassante matchup, which we've seen a gazillion times these days. The using Maokai ult here for counter engage could be pretty huge, though. Like, the counter-engage, by the way, from top esports is really massive. So you have Maokai ult, Chain of Corruption, you have Rell, right? You have the Azir wall. So primary engage over here, you have non-committal engage with Ash Arrow, and you can kind of run at them. The Xin Zhao ult, you know, you can engage, and he can be a ball delivery system for Orianna. But it's not super reliable. And honestly, if the Ash Arrow doesn't hit, the just run at them style, or if Xin Zhao ult is down, it's very kiteable and very easy to disengage for top esports. Very easy. So I'm kind of concerned about RNG because the just run at them comps going to have a hard time versus the comp that top esports is running. It just feels like there's too much disengage on top esports side. I don't know why the color of the screen is weird, guys. Don't ask. Just how the VOD is. Can Cream play Azir now? I guess we're gonna find out. Yeah, somebody messed with this on the broadcast, I guess, guys, because like somebody fucked with the color on the broadcast. That's why it looks like this.
Mm. 这个线不好上去闻啊。
迎击长空，找一下，也看到了小天的位置。一个是看到小天的位置，还有就也清楚，就小天他是从下半区往上去开，这也就导致 RNG 双人组他实际上可以长时间保持这种压制。没错。再继续强二的压制，击双射手他就是挖的很准，没口直接半血，至少都可以挡住你第一波。哎，一点点试探，从刃。
I mean, I don't really know what Mako's doing. Like, he took E at level 1, and he just eats a fuck ton of damage from Hail of Blades Ash. Very, very interesting level 1 maneuver from top esports bot lane. Yeah, I don't know why the color's messed up, guys. Sorry. Really slow early game. Okay, jungler's back on the map now after first buy. Tang Yuan doing a good job of winning this matchup early. I mean, we've seen the Ori kind of dominate this matchup early on. The Azir does extremely well in side lanes later on in the game, though. He used Smite on the last one? Okay. Alright then. 369 casually face checking this brush with there could obviously be a level 6 Kassante in it. Pretty interesting decision there. Where did he think Kassante went? Kassante was in top lane. Where did he think he went?
Yeah,
It's a good play by RNG, but where did he think he went? T1 uses the grabs well, everyone else does, and T1 uses them the best. Gen.G also uses them very well. I think good teams will be able to make very good use of grubs. Watch some of T1's games where they have six void grubs, though, and you'll see they really push limits with that. Well, he still got hit by Chain of Corruption, though. Jackie Love already six, so LP tries to drag him in with Flash. Baco keeps his composure, still Q's there. Manages to hit him straight in Chain of Corruption, then just a few autos and a Q. Takes him out. Still has heal, Jackie Love, so gets Mako out. Nice play. Where is the spell shield? I do like the instant flash play here. Did they see him use the spell shield earlier? It's weird. What happened? Why didn't he have spell shield? Because he gets chain CC'd, so I don't think he has a chance. No, he could have used it there on Chain of Corruption because he moves. Yeah, he might have used it on a sapling, maybe. Like, maybe there was a sapling in this brush that he used it on, and that's what they saw. I can't tell, though. Let me go back a little bit further. There's this watermark that makes it difficult to see, though. I actually have no idea. Maybe it was a sapling. That's my best guess. There may have been a sapling in that brush that he used his E on, and then that was where Mako decided to make the play. Because it didn't look like he had E up there. It wasn't that he was chain CC'd. He didn't use it on the W, which is why he flashed. You know, they must have known that he didn't have E. Because otherwise, why would Maokai flash W him? So that's the only thing that makes sense. Do you think Mako is the best support Jackie Love has had so far? Probably. I mean, Mako might be the best support of all time. Like, that's an argument I feel like you can make. He couldn't react in time? I mean, he flashed, so he could definitely press E. He flashed the Maokai flash W instead of just hitting E, so I assume he doesn't have it.
Mm. 这还是W改了一下呢，对，直接给在中路落头。
I love that the top match of Kassante and Aatrox is just two champions that spam Q at each other the entire laning phase. Nice force of flash there. Why isn't Aatrox pushed in by Kassante? Aatrox has better wave clear. He has more AoE. Is that a beer? No, it is a Pellegrino blood orange and black raspberry seltzer. Alcohol? No. I wouldn't drink on stream. I also don't drink in February, so I haven't drank it all this month. Does NIP or IG crack top 10 power rankings now? We shall see about IG. I mean, with LNG falling out, I feel it's like kind of obvious that one of them. We'll see how NIP does by the end, you know, by the end of this week, though, because we got to wait for a real NIP match. But NIP only play LNG later this week, so we still may not have enough to put NIP in there. IG have to be frauds. IG are definitely frauds, to be clear. BLG played a very bad series. Like, Jun just fucking trolled in the second game. Dude, his invade where he lost the blue buff anyway and got Giga behind Graves was so bad. Alright, Cream. Just get hit by an arrow. Should we flash the arrow? Nah. I'd rather just eat a 3-second stun, use my ult, and die. Yep. Okay, then.
RNG
Jerky Smitty, holy shit. You see far too few subs in this. You know the way to fix it. Thank you for your 20 gift subs. That's very generous of you. Thank you, Jerky's Minion. That's very nice. Now we can just listen to 20 all aboard the Korean hype trains. Thanks to Jerky's Minion. Very much appreciated, man. Hope you're doing well. So many new Yordhole enthusiasts, but not you, Byray PL. Not you. You wouldn't touch a Yordhole with a 10-foot Yord pole. Do you think quality of the LPL as a whole is not as good as last year? Yes, so far. But, you know, it's really early on in the year, so. Crushed my back workout. Deadlifted 220 kilograms. Holy shit, man. Impressive. So now now that Nashor's is done, we start getting the Azir split push. He doesn't have TP, but Top Esports is going to go for this anyway. Okay, everybody goes over the wall, and it's fine. By Ray PL, thank you for your tier 1 sub. I appreciate it. Oh, he got the chains? Oh my god. Oh my god, he takes turret aggro too. So he takes turret aggro right there. With the ball, tries to run through the turret. Then the punish comes through from 369. Oh my god, after flash. The chains coming in, just straight into the slam. Oh my god. Oh my god, he's doing it. He's doing it. 369 is huge. Wow. That's such a baller play. Gets hit by the arrow, but he has too much sustain. He has too much sustain while he's in ult, so he forces Wei's flash. Right, Ming has to flash then too because he gets CC'd. The Xin Zhao W misses, and now he's just coming up to finish him off. Wow. Wow, 369. Huge play. Dude, if you guys didn't see his play at the end of the game 2 of Weibo versus Top Esports, where he just like hero wins the game on Rumble when they should definitely lose. Worth your time. And then, of course, we have the Sivir recall. And Cream is randomly there, coming in from this his bot lane push. Yeah, Jerky's been. It's game two of Top versus Weibo. It's at the very, very end of the game. It's a long game, but he has a insane rumble play to win the game. See, the thing about Aatrox is that when he has 100 HP, he actually has 1,000 HP. That's the thing you have to remember. His health bar says 100, but it means 1,000. All right, so Drake stacking now stopped. Smell of dog, first message, yo. He's brought the stink to my channel. Smell of dog and dog rat. Now we just need smell of dog rat, and we will have completed the trifecta in my chat. You might even give me your prime. Wow. How generous of you. Do you think I've earned it? Smell of dog. Didn't know you were a streamer. Well, I've been streaming a lot these days. I have not been a streamer, but been streaming. I streamed all the games of Worlds last year, did VOD reviews of all of those, and we've been doing it since the start of this season too. Just we've been curating the best games of League of Legends. You were my favorite caster back when there was no prime to give out. I know, man. I remember the days. I remember the days of no prime because it was actually impossible to make money on Twitch as a streamer. Even if you were getting like 15K concurrence like I was at times, it was still impossible to make money. It's okay. It's going to be impossible to make money on Twitch again soon because they're nerfing Twitch Prime super hard for streamers.
Mm.
Well, I won't be casting games, but I'll be providing plenty of commentary for you on my shows, doing six podcasts and also streaming. Was I a conductor? A hype train conductor. All right, 369 on the flank here. Let's go. I'm excited to see if RNG decides to take this, try and go for this Drake. They have no idea where 369 is, by the way. All right, so good setup just to go ahead and clear this out. RNG get absolutely nothing. Well, I have a stream on Kick. Does anybody watch anything on Kick? Can you imagine Top's comp with Quadra Infernal? Yeah, that seems really rough. The Varus and Azir poke would be pretty out of control. Are you still going to stream on Twitch after it shuts down in Korea? Yeah, it doesn't affect me, guys. The Twitch shutdown in Korea does not affect me at all. Because my viewers are not in Korea, right? And the reason they're shutting down Twitch in Korea is because the Korean ISPs are trying to charge everybody for traffic because there are no net neutrality laws. And so if you are receiving money through a non-Korean bank account and you still have viewers who are not Korean, which is like all of my viewers basically, then yes. But I'm also multi-streaming anyway. So even if you were in Korea, you could watch me on YouTube. I'm literally streaming on YouTube as well right now. I stream on both platforms. Smell of dog, you're in Korea? Well, you can just watch on YouTube, buddy. Or you can VPN, which I'm sure a bunch of people in Korea are going to do. I'm VPN'd right now. I already have to VPN to stream, guys, because if I don't, my VODs don't get saved onto Twitch. Is it true Koreans love to eat dogs? No. So first off, it's very rare. Okay, there's a couple things about that. It was actually just made illegal. So it is actually illegal now in Korea to kill dogs for food. But even the dog soup restaurants that you could go to, there were not very many of them, and most people didn't do it anyway. It's not common. It wasn't common anyway, and now it's actually illegal. How good is your connection should be to stream on two platforms and use VPN at the same time? I mean, everywhere in Korea is fiber, so that's one of the big advantages of living in Korea is that the internet is just god tier everywhere. So I have a 1,000 up, 1,000 down. It's not a big deal at all. My Korean roommates took me to eat pig's feet. Oh, those are very common, though. That's a very common food. It's not my favorite, but it's all right. Multi-streaming doesn't use double bandwidth? No, it does. It does, because you're uploading the same video to two different streams. No, I don't use a third-party service. I don't have to. You can do that. You can use a third-party service where you upload to one server and then it splits it for you. But I just upload to both because I have plenty of bandwidth. What VPN do I use? ExpressVPN. ExpressVPN.com/summoning for 3 free months, and you get to support Summoning Insight. So there you go. The actual video is frozen, guys. This, I thought I paused it, but it's just actually frozen. That's wild. Okay, the feed froze. Shameless plugging? Of course. Do you want me to make a living or not? Do you want LFN to exist or not? How do you expect me to make a living, man? Give me food? What does that mean? All right, so we're just going to stack up to... We're just going to push the mid wave and then just stack up to 4 Infernal Drakes with a poke composition. Seems fun. RNG, you want to do something with your pick comp? You want to, like, make a pick with an Ash Arrow or a Sivir Ult, please? It's a good bait. There you go. They made a pick. All right. Cost them a turret, but they got a big shutdown. Do I follow K-pop? No, K-pop is hot trash that should be destroyed. K-pop is a blight upon humanity. I am unsubbing. I'm just doing you a favor, man. I'm trying to have you listen to music that wasn't, you know, grown in a laboratory. The K-pop industry is also just incredibly abusive to the actual K-pop artists, too, so... New jeans are cute as fuck. The girls are super cute. No, I'm not into Korean teenage girls. Sorry. Hard pass. Are they typically xenophobic to Western beam? No. No.
No.
The one arrow that doesn't hit Cream then just results in Breathe's death. Do I stream LCK today? I will stream again tomorrow. I'll be streaming tomorrow. What games will be watching? I don't know. All the games suck. So we will see which games I end up watching. I've been fine the last couple of years, Mel and Flame. What's my favorite Korean food? I like all Korean food, man. I'm not particularly picky. I cook a bunch of different Korean food myself, so. This game has been kind of done for a while. Ever since Top Esports just gets every dragon uncontested. There have been some nice arrows from Ming this game, and he's unstoppable, so Cream's wall does nothing. Way able to get over it with the Z. But they're still under an Azir turret. Nice catch on Cream with the shockwave. But Breathe has no resists. Everybody just exploding in a pile of cinders. Oh, they baited him in. They baited him in so 369 could get it. Now he's going to get out and TP back in if we're Cream and end the game, right? Surely we just end the game here. Yes. Didn't even get Infernal Soul. Didn't even need it. If I only have one time for one banger VOD from tonight, probably KT HLE Game 1. I think that was the most interesting one. It's a pretty fun game. It's long, though. I'm not sold on the way these teams are playing Sivir Ashe. It's been pretty miserable. Is it true that Jeju Island is like the Hawaii of Korea? I mean, it's not as nice as Hawaii, but it is nice. It's not tropical like Hawaii is, you know? But it's like nice and warm, and it's very beautiful. What's it like to be sort of famous? Like, depending on where you are, people will know who you are. How does it... It doesn't really impact my life, guys. I'm the proper amount of famous where if, like, if I go somewhere where people are likely to know me, you know, like league events, or I get occasionally recognized, you know, while I'm out in the street. So it's fine because, like, it's not annoying. You know what I mean? And it's not constant. It's just occasional. Nautilus ban again. I wonder if this is just going to become a more common ban, or do they just really want this one versus Ming. Kalista gets through this time. Ashe gets banned. So we're still on 14-2, so the Nico is enabled. Renata Glask, and wow, interesting that you take the Renata so early. Like, it just feels like now you maybe just take Blitz, right? Or you take Viego so you can actually stun CC the Renata. Huge like engage here from this trio of champions. Why are we banning Jax? Maokai makes it all the way through. So again, it could be Maokai support here. Maokai support seems very good into Kalista and Renata. But you have a flex opportunity. Oh, he's definitely going to be support, obviously, because the Viego's already taken. Alright, we're going to play the Yone into Azir. Matchup that we've seen quite a bit. Yeah, the Maokai seems quite strong into... The Maokai support seems quite strong into the Kalista-Renata combo. A lot of all-in potential, especially with the Viego coming bot as well. I recognize Joe at a Warhammer store. Oh, were you at the one in Glendale? Because he used to go to that one, I know. I know he used to go to that one. That is the store, Monte, yeah. When we used to play Legends of Five Rings, we would go to... Paper Heroes and Burbank, and we would play that together there, the L5R card game, and we did get recognized there. Whatever this VOD has done to the saturation makes it look feel a lot like the old map. Yeah, it's totally true. It does feel like the old map. I had that thought too, Adanian. Was I a Crane player? No, I was Phoenix. Doe is Unicorn. You can always have a photo, Nacho Libre, no problem. Crab Clan. I did play a little bit of Crab. I'm so sad Fantasy Flight shut down that game though. It was my favorite card game that I've ever played. So fucking hard. The crazy thing about that L5R game, guys, was that it was a card game, right, where it had such low RNG and such a high skill ceiling that, not joking you, the best players in the world would win like 90% of the time on paper. So the variance was very low. I mean, if you think about Magic in comparison, where like you're a god if you have like a 60% win rate. Yeah, that game was like so low RNG, so high skill. I miss it. What's the name of the card game? Legend of the Five Rings, L5R. The Fantasy Flight version that they made. Then I started playing Flesh and Blood a little bit with Uber and Doe, and that game's really good too. I was enjoying myself on that. But finding time to, like, go to tournaments and stuff was really hard once I had a kid. So, I couldn't play as much Flesh and Blood as I would have liked.
Thank you. 可能就没有队友去真正能帮了，就一直被压。是的，现在下路已经被压了十五刀了。
Yeah, this engage seems so strong, by the way. I really feel like the Maokai support was such a good pick here. It's not something that I've seen into Renata and Kalista before, but, I mean, you can see how effective it is. And the other thing, too, is that with the Maokai, even in the mid and late game, because your ult is so huge, if you see that Renata ult coming towards you, you can just counter Maokai ult in response. And there's really nothing that the Renata ult is going to be able to do. Like, it prevents them from following up on Renata ult. And it's also bigger than Renata ult. So, like, I feel like the Renata here was kind of a bait, honestly. Like, you literally... Like, look how this goes. Because you die right at 5 minutes, and your jungler's topside... You can't even use your Kalista to take first Drake. And it feels like one of your win conditions is just kind of slipping away. I mean, the primary engage here is so huge, too. I mean, what's crazy is I know that top esports win this game. But it just feels like this composition is so good. And it's really good with the Viego, too, because the number of Viego resets, it's going to be very easy to get with the amount of crowd control. You know, and focus fire on RNG feels like Wei should just be going crazy in team fights. I'm very curious to see how top win this, because I'm definitely much bigger fan of RNG's draft. Children killed my D&D group 3 years of playing every Friday. One guy is a kid. Boom, we don't play consistently, maybe once a month. I mean, frankly, I feel that's on your friend. Like, the reason I wasn't playing Flesh and Blood when I had a kid is because I was just prioritizing other things. I was prioritizing Muay Thai, so, and especially Muay Thai sparring, which I could only do in the evening. So I had to, you know, when I had my wife home to take care of the kid, I just chose to go to, like, spar. Instead of choosing a knight to go play cards. You know what I mean? So it's definitely possible, especially if they have a partner who can take care of the kid. And it's not unreasonable to ask your spouse to take care of the kid like one evening a week so you can go do something you enjoy. So I feel like that's that guy's problem. That's what I'm saying. Like, either he doesn't want to, you know, have that discussion with his significant other and, like, make a compromise with that person, or he's just prioritizing non-D&D things.
RNG来讲还真需要呼吸哥单线去打出一些东西，是他得打出足够大的优势才行，就弥补掉下路的那个劣势。对，而且打团对于呼吸哥来讲。
Both these games have had extremely slow starts, actually. So much about Drake control, too. Tian, think he's being cute on this Drake spawn. Really big CS gap in the bot, though. Surely top doesn't just let this go for free. Surely. Why are we Maokai ulting so early? Okay, well, they... Alright. Why are we Maokai ulting so early? Alright, look at that. He casts the Renata ult and gets pulled in by Kalista ult. Okay. Oh! Nice. Got 1 billion spears in there. Do you think no priest is affecting pros this season? Yeah, absolutely. You know, there, and especially because, guys, the game changed more this year than it has in the past couple of years. You know what I mean? Like, the changes this year were truly massive, whereas past couple of years, the game hasn't changed that much. I'm just confused as to why Ming throws out this Maokai ult so early on. Right? Because they don't actually have a lot of success engaging on it. And LP has to burn his cleanse right off the bat. They re-engage with that ult and force his flash. Re-engage with the Kalista ult. Yeah, that Maokai ult doesn't make any sense to me. They didn't have any follow-up for it. And I guess we're just going to snowball off this position because now you just win bot lane even harder. Maybe to set up for Nico? I mean, yeah, but you're engaging onto Kalista ult. Right? You're engaging onto Kalista ult. So, I mean, he gets one knockup, but it's too late also, because they already kill Cream by the time the Nico ult comes through. It's a badly coordinated engage. I do read this chat, David Kai. I do read the YouTube chat, yes. I do try and check in with you YouTube people. Well, you see, guys, Riot couldn't do a 3-month preseason because they had to finish designing the new patch, and then they had to go on several weeks of vacation over Christmas and the holidays. So, you know, the pros just get screwed. because they don't plan their time effectively. And then they all have to take a vacation at the same time. Huge lead in the bot side now. Also, casual Ocean Soul again, so should be pretty crazy for the Aatrox team. Right? Pretty crazy for Kalista, too. Power Spike soonish? No, Power Spike is going to be on Friday night. We had to move the scheduling around a little bit. Sorry about that. It'll be coming, though. Isn't the viewer experience better in terms of champion diversity? What is the correlation between releasing the patch earlier and champion diversity? For all we know, it reduced champion diversity because people were unwilling to experiment because they didn't understand the new map or item builds. Like, what is your proof that there was more champion diversity because there was no preseason? I don't understand. Oh my god. Is he gonna spend the entire fucking game just Nico ulting while Kalista ult is up? Okay, well, I guess that's a thing. Actual zero value Nico ult again. Look at it, it's the same play. Maokai ult hits one person, by the way. One person hits the Renata Glask. Renata pulls them in. Hits Kalista, but there's no follow-up. Kalista has already pulled Renata Glask out. They're all clustered, get mad knocked up. Where's Mako's ult here? It's literally exactly the same play. So there's the Renata ult. Has no value. Why he did it that way, I don't know. But it doesn't matter because Cream is here, gets a three-man Azir wall. So Top Esports just completely owns them in a choke point after we have another fail Maokai Nico ult. Maokai Nico ult get zero value again. How does that happen? How do you have Maokai and Nico ults and you get zero value? And look at this. He almost doesn't even hit Jackie Love. Huge knockup, huge play by Cream coming in. It's a great Azir play by Cream for a guy who doesn't play very much Azir. These engages by RNG are so fucking telegraphed though.
Yeah.
Like, it's just so obvious. Like, top esports is just reading the play every time. Can't wait for them to do it again, by the way. Cream is the player Zekka wishes he was. Yeah, that's true. But Cream ain't a world champion yet. I mean, I'd be okay with top esports winning worlds. Get some more rings for Tien and Jackie Love. And Mako, yes, and Mako. Here we go. Here's the Maokai ult to get. It's coming in again, guys. One helmet head. Thank you for your Twitch Prime sub. Is this the last match review today? Yes. What the fuck happened there? He actually got Jin ulted out. He got fucking Jin ulted out. He got Jin ulted out. I was like, why did he get knocked back? Where's Mako's ult? There it is. All right. They finally get the Viego resets. And yet, it's not enough. Because they do it while Aatrox isn't there, but Aatrox just TPs in directly on top. He TPs in directly on top of LP. Here's the TP, guys. Right on top of LP. And there's no more peel. What a hero Jhin ult, by the way. Tien, just doing great. Watch the last four horsemen, man. What you said about Riot Games and their cult was something. It's so crazy. It's so crazy. The Riot people are deep Kool-Aided, man. Why aren't you reviewing IG versus BLG? Because I fucking did it yesterday. The angry Lynx. Here you go. It's also on my main YouTube channel if you just want the entire live broadcast. If you want individual games, it's on Bangers Only. If you want the entire block broadcast, it's on my main channel in the live tab. I like how we go from this fight directly into a fight in the jungle. God, Aatrox just lifesteal tanking this entire fight. So, Angry Lynx, next time you come into somebody's chat and drop your first message, maybe you should start with, have you FOD reviewed IG versus BLG? Not, why aren't you doing it? Because you don't fucking know. Hmm? You don't fucking know.
Cool. 面对这个大龙 buff 的推进，看看有没有什么那种能在野区蹲到一个人来，
还是
想方设法阻止一下。
BP 压力太大了，
对
，BP 压力太大了。我们看 Cream 怎么做到的，飘到了脸上戳戳。
WA， 哦。
Wow, what an inspiring play. Man, LP has been, his positioning has been really bad this game, but guys. I hated this guy when he was on LNG because he was like the worst player on LNG and was really holding them back until they got Gala in the summer. But this guy is just like standing next to Aatrox's teleporting in. He's getting backlined every single game. Just getting 1v1 by his ear. Yeah, this RNG team is pretty shit, honestly. Their coordination is like giga bad. Giga bad, not giga Chad. Are you planning to expand to Dota 2? Maybe. We need shows in Dota 2. I know Cap just started a show in Dota 2 that's been doing all right. I talked to him a little bit about that. Pretty boring game, guys, but honestly, RNG just kind of threw with their composition. They also got giga-bodied in terms of CS in the bot lane. Dude, Ming's fucking Maokai ults this whole game are just killing me. Wow, Cream, damn. Big ult as arm guard. Tanguan gets, oh my god, Tien ults him again? This guy's just never, he's just not allowed. Oh, he didn't even ult him. What the fuck knocked him back? What knocked him back? Oh, it was it Yone ult? I can't see what knocked him back. Because Tien's ult comes out right there. I can't even tell it knocked him back. Renata Q? It must have been Renata Q. That's the only thing I can see. It's actually such a hero play. Yeah, it was Renata Q, I guess. That's huge. He gets handshook out of his ult again. There were, like, no good Nico ults this entire game. Avani Ukami, thank you. Good night to you in California. That's going to be it for today, guys. Pretty low-key day. KT as fraudulent as we thought. Top esports looking really good. Definitely like a top 5 team in the world right now. Exciting to see them. 369, absolutely dominating. Do I ever play any league? Not much. There's no point. Like, I don't need mechanics to do what I do. So why would I waste my time when I could instead be VOD reviewing with you guys? What do I get from being, like, good in solo queue? Nothing. It teaches me nothing about the professional scene. Yeah, clean series for top. We will be back tomorrow. Maybe we'll watch NIP EDG, maybe. I guess that's what we're going to have to watch tomorrow, guys. Because I'm certainly not watching Thunder Talk Absolute Legends or Rare Adam OMG. That sounds pretty miserable. What else we got? We got some garbage. We have some garbage matchups in LCK too. They're starting right now. They just started. D plus Fox or Gen G. We'll probably watch the Gen G games for fun. Probably watch the Gen G games for fun. But you guys can go watch LCK now. I will catch you later. Thanks for watching.